Oh my God. Okay, fine. Well, here I am. Hello, hello, ooh. Hello, piano lizard. I don't believe I have ever felt so ill prepared for anything in my life.
And some things just don't change, do they? Do they, dear Mason? Do they? Aha! It's me, the real Mason! Sir Mason, it is I, Mason Apastra, son of the stars. And I do welcome you all with cold hospitality, but to my 100th celebration stream. And that lowly schmuck you saw there, that was Mason on his first ever stream. Little old Mason, little old me. Oh, how are you doing today, guys? How are you doing? Let's get a bit of music going on. Let's get a bit of music. Go on, have this one. No. Oh my fucking God, that is not the right music. Some things really don't change, do they? There we go. There we go. There we go. Oh my God. Ah, YouTube Studio, what are you doing? Oh no. The studio's reopened itself. Oh my God, I'm still as scuff as ever. Oh, hi guys. Hello, hello. Hello. Oh, who we got today? So we have a Trixie, but of course we do. Hello, Trixie. We have here a Zego. Thank you very much for the resubscription as well. Very grateful indeed. Thank you very much, sir. We have a local. Hello, local. And that is it for the now. So yeah, here we are. It's been 100 streams. It's been more than a year. More than a year at this point. Still going. Still going. So yeah, good to have you people. Good to have you. What we got? You are fa- Why do I keep saying you are failed? It's very strange that. By the way, people, if you want to have a pixel art done for you, the stream, just type in exclamation point join and give a description of what you would like drawn. And take them there. Ah. Did I get you with that one, guys? I think I got you. Even Trixie saying, "Oh my God!" I mean, I God must have done something right there. Face up, Luna, son of the moons. Is a moon? No, a moon's not a star. How dare you? How dare you compare a star to a lonely moon? Click the steam button. I've been up here 9 months. Yeah, that is. You've been came here pretty early. Both of you have, honestly. Yeah, like, pretty sure Zego came first. Then it'd be you, local, then Trixie, I believe. Oh no, you tell me, Mason, what have you failed at? I don't know. I'm not the one who keeps making this message. Jesus. You got me, that's for sure. Yay, got someone. Thought you were gonna be the first join, but it was I, Trix. Ah, oh, good. Glad you enjoyed it. Glad you enjoyed it. I'm gonna meet. Wait, you Loco actually followed me before you. I know you weren't there like right away, Zego, but ah, I didn't think so. Fair play. Then we are like having a conversation. And I was like, "Oh yeah, I also do streams and stuff." And he was like, "Wait, what? You do streams?" I remember that. You started the message, and I kept going with it. Or was it not you, but someone talking your stream intro? Oh. Orb is first? Well, the first follower I've ever had. Best follower I've ever had. I can actually verify that now. In fact, it's not on screen right now, so that's fine. I can actually see who was the first ever follower I've had. We're gonna go back in history. Are regulars? Ah, of course. So, the first person to ever subscribe to me was actually Petri. Petri Coral was the first person to ever subscribe to this channel. Oh, not subscribe, sorry. Follow the channel. My God. It was Petri. Oh, that's quite funny. Fucking hell. That's unexpected. Bloody Petri. Alright, cool. I'll take it. Alright, so what are we gonna do? We're gonna put on here. I guess you could say you invited me, but even if instead of just doing a regular tab stream and not tournament, I probably went to the stream that day. How did people discover me? Space Movie followed me first. It's true. Space Movie did follow me first. I'm but the son of the stars. She is the mum of the stars. Okay, so, of course, the meat of our stream today is going to be some pixel art. I just thought you found you through the tabs. Oh, you literally just typed in like tabs and just was like, oh, this guy. Who's this? Like, let's look at this person's tabs content. Fair. Okay, so, yeah, today a bulk of our content will be pixel art, of course. How it's going to work is some of you guys already queued up, which is good. You're going to be randomly picked, so it's not in order of selection. Sorry, Trixie. Reaper King very shortly after, I believe, yeah. Yeah, like, Reaper King was not far behind at all. Reaper King? You, Trixie, what are you saying? Hehe. Yeah, so what's not gonna happen is we're gonna spin a wheel, a la roguelike roulette, I suppose. Very similar to that. And it will determine the size of your pixel art. And yeah, we'll just see how it goes from there. I've done pixel art for many years, but I am rusty compared to my past self. Plus, I am terrible at doing things fast, and I'm even worse when people are looking at me. So, word of warning, it's going to be some very scuffed pixel art. Probably very cursed, to be honest, but I'll do what I can for you folks. Do what I can. Alrighty, so, let's switch on over. To which screen will it be? It'll be this one right here. Lovely stuff. Okay. So, it's exclamation point join. Join. Point join. May snap emotes. Ooh. Interesting. Oops, that's not what you're meant to see. It's on our screen. Alright, cool. Even Mason be like, I like swords and hit. What? Dare you. I do unironically like swords though. Swords are alright. But mace is all the way. Oh my god, love a mace. Okay, so. Our first size of pixel art is going to be... So, here's our sizes. 128 is going to be the biggest, because that will take fucking forever, if it's going to be any good. We have, for the sake of memes, we have a fucking 8x8. Most of them are 32x32. And we have 116x16 as well, apparently. So, yeah, let's give it a spin, and then we'll choose who it goes first, out of random. This will be an interesting little experiment, I guess. I thought, you know, a time like this would be the perfect time for it. Big celebration, all that. Okay, so we're going to be doing a 32x32. I'm just going to introduce you to my software of choice. Boom! Well, I mean, you can't see the interface anyway. So this is Marmoset Hexels. It's not a very well-known software. I was introduced to it when I was in education. and it's just been my go-to pixel art program ever since. So yeah. You have hex? Why the fuck do you have hexels for? There you go. That's really random. Hexels is such a weird, quirky software that has relatively little purpose. Because of me. Oh, did I literally convince you at the time? I was like, oh, I love hexels. Hexels are the fucking best. There you go. You should have it. Oh my god, that's actually quite funny. I like that. It's because of you. You, Mason. You did this. All right. So, our first victim, receiver of art, shall be... It is... Digo! It's actually you, who also ironically have two leftover prizes from the Maytabs tourney as well to redeem sometime. But pixel art this time, okay. I asked my recommendation for making pixel art. Oh, there we go then. That would be why. Okay, we're going to change the music up a bit. We're going to go back to something I only really played at the pretty early streams, really. So let's have this back, if any of you recognize this playlist. Bit quiet. Not meant to be very loud, mind. Okay. How's that? Is that okay volume? Hope that's okay volume. I have done pixel art in the past using paint, but not really something big, and I did use the circle tool. Oh my god. Oh, bloody hell. Good old circles. Oh, you're trying to make circular pixels, is it? Or did you like... Oh, hang on. Oh, yes. I'm not used to using this particular setup right now. So normally, when I've done my pixel art, I do it on a different computer than this one. So it's all a little bit alien to me at the moment. Anyways, bog standard hotkeys and all that, shall we say. Okay, make yourself a new emote or at least plan for... Bloody hell, a new emote? Oh my god, okay, sure. Alright, so it's a 32 by 32. So we'll be using this size here. We're going to use... I have an idea. Oh, go on then. What's your idea, Zigo? Go for it. Mace raid emote. Ooh, okay. That's interesting. So I mean, like, when a raid happens to this channel, I usually have like a war horn, don't I? Like a bugle or something. I don't know, maybe I could have something like that. Let's see. What can we come up with? So I'm going to be using a palette right now that I call... Oh, I can't really say the name of it because I'll say something. But I'm using basically a custom palette that I established a long time ago now. Like, it's like the palette's like 2 years old now. It's made of 52 colours. I was on Creative Arts from the pixel art I did. Ooh, go on. Let's have a look. Ooh, nice. It's like a shield sort of job. Yeah, no, that's good. Good. I can see what you mean. You started off with a pixel tool to get the basic shape. Yeah, I mean, I suppose that's the thing. I don't really think much about it, but there is like an art to making circles in pixel art, really. I mean, sure, we have a circle tool on here, but that's an ugly circle. There's lots of ways you can go about circles in pixel art. Lots of ways. Like, you know, there's like... Let's see, I don't know. Let's see, it's like a... Let's do a 8x8, let's say. We want to fit an 8x8 circle. Is this all coming up on your screen? I hope it's coming up on your screen. Yeah, it's coming up. Okay. An 8x8 circle. 1x9, 8x8. So, yeah, like, let's see. It's like... Oops. Like this sort of deal where you start off like that. You could do that, but it ends up like a diamond basically. That's like your lazy method. A lot of brushes will do this sort of shape. It makes it very jagged. But the best way, in my opinion, to make circles is to have really, like, big, really big sides. So, like, do that, 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 do that. It gives things a more puffy look, but it makes something that is definitely a circle. Right? That's a circle. Circle, right there. I've played enough Minecraft, I know it's a circle. Very good, very good. Okay, right, let's actually have a think then. What should we do for a mace raid? What would I do for my victims? I like geometrical shapes as a whole. Ah, well. Oh shit, is it actually on there? I don't know if I updated it. Oh shit, it's not. Hang on, I need to update the table. Whoops. Is that correct? Ah, yeah, so there wasn't actually an option on the table. Actually, I can move one of these, one sec. There was actually an option on the roulette wheel for a thing called Trixels, which you'll probably like Trixie, because it's literally called Trixels. And they're literally like triangles instead of squares. It's quite an interesting form of art I've done before. I kind of battle horn blowing? Yeah, a battle horn blowing. Okay. Right. This is going to take some real getting used to. I'm not used to this setup at all. I think I've told people before, my monitor's about 2 meters away from me. So it's a bit weird to me. I should rename to Trixels. Do some Trixel art. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Right. So let's say if we have like a war horn. Okay. Start off like this. Make a really chintzy sketch at first. Let's say this is the start of the horn. So yeah, what I do first is I make a really, really shit start. Something like this. We'll do that. We'll get some mason flesh. Mason flesh over here. The best flesh we got on this palette. Oh yes, lovely stuff. Has the music stopped? Okay, it's not. All good. Wait, what, say raid? Yeah, like on the bottom, right? Like raid. I should probably think of that first. Actually, no, I'll add it on later. It's fine. It's fine. Okay, so we're going to add... we're going to add a brown palette on you as well. The hood. I've actually got any emotes of me without my hood on. Oh yes, that's perfect. Oh yes, that's very mason shape, yes. Well, a nice big head. Nice big fat head so you can see me. Oh shite. Yeah, this mouse is not it's not the one. Hey, Shadow Legends! Oh no, that's the dumb. The dumb has... Oh, and the heart. Okay, dumb and heart both have me with my hood down. Okay. That's cool. It's good to know. Yeah, none of them are actually pixel art. That's strange, really. Considering, like, follow and raid notifications are pixel art. Yeah, like, I made the my own notification art as well. Like, this person hasn't just followed, I'm just gonna reuse it now. I got a mace, I got a mace. That there. I got a mace. And that was only a few hours work, really. Thanks, Devi, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, you got singled out, mate. Singled out. Okay, so. How are we gonna do this? This is a bit weird. I've got quite a lot I want to fit into 32 by 32, really. Right, how about a mace over here? So I got, like, I'm holding this bugle in, like, one hand. Like, bleh, 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 like that. Have to make a new color for that as well. I get a basic idea. And I'm not on the right layer either, that's bad. Whoops. Oh well. I'll try not to cry. Let's see. So, yeah, do that. Okay, so we'll be holding that. We'll have an Armatonia. We can actually have that there. Lovely. Yeah, I totally get the love of geometric sort of art. I just really like the idea of not relying on brushes so much, because brushes can be, have like, they sort of do what they want. With like pixel art or any kind of grid-based art, like even ASCII art, anything like that, you basically dictate exactly what's happening. There's not going to be any stray like elements. It's all going to be, this square will have this color. There's no like patches, there's no blurring, all just raw and as desired. Everything by design. Right, well, for a start, I don't have a bare arm on my left, do I? I have a sleeve. Sleeve on my arm, yeah. Nice. Yeah, no, this mouse is really hard to use. Gotta be honest. Jesus Christ. Fighting me. The fine motions I must make. Right. Where does my body end? Where's my body end, guys? Where does it end? My all legs? Maybe I'm all legs.
Am I wasting my time?
What could we say? You reckon a horn could be saying raid? How would I? How would I make this horn say raid? Oh, is it like raid, like along the top? Like a curve over your head. Oh, I see. Ooh, I see. That would be.
Why are you wasting your time? Am I wasting my time?
That's gonna be hard to do with the amount of pixels I have. The problem with 32x32 it is quite restrictive. Initially, what I was thinking of doing was something along the lines of, like a little box down here. It's gonna be like a little shockwave on it. There's like sound. Like a little line coming from it. Like raid. Raid. Perfect. Like that. That's my initial plan. I think over the top would make more sense for a bugle, right? A war bugle. I'm using geometrical shape. Ah, shit, I'm gonna move this and it's gonna. I did it on wrong layer. Whoops. Whoops. Wrong layer. Whoops. Whoops. Put the fuck up, layers. No one likes you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, God. Oh, God. No. No. Okay, I understand now. I understand my variety of fuck up. There we go. That's better. Oof. Yeah, if I do something like that. I like using geometrical shapes because I get what I ask for every time and not depending on moving my mouse 1 millimeter. Yeah, yeah. I get that. Especially if you have like a drawing tablet and you've got to depend on like how hard you press it and the angle sometimes as well, depending on how good your thing is. Alright. If I were to do it, it'd be framed like. Frame like that, I guess. Is that clear from a distance? I mean, if it's as big as an actual emote, it'd be like that, probably, right? Or even smaller. Yeah, like a 32x32 emote is a tricky one, to say the least. Alright, we're gonna make this red. I've decided this will be red. Actually looks pretty good, you reckon? I mean, I can already see the capture, I suppose, so it's even smaller for me. I don't know, what does everyone think? You like his ego. Raid or paid? Paid Shadow Legends, baby! I'll be paid by Raid Shadow Legends. That's a stream I'll definitely want to do one day, just for the shits and giggles. Get that sick sponsorship stream from Raid Shadow Legends. I feel like that's like the rite of passage for any tuber. I like it. You need an eye. I do need an eye. I absolutely bloody do. I need a lot. Alright, what we'll do is we'll make a groove down the middle here. Yeah, I'm not sure how detailed to go with it, because when you add detail to something like this, it can actually reduce the clarity somewhat. It's always a bit difficult to balance it. Like, I think an eye would be a good idea. I try and make out what things you can see from a distance. I can see on my face, I can see my shoulder pad, I can see the hood, I can see a bugle, I can see it says raid. / paid. What I hate is why are there no digital tools that replicate IRL tools such as the Geometry Math Compass? Well, I mean like the tool that allows draw. Oh yeah, I know those. Oh, I see. So like, yeah, no, I got you. I suppose it's basically replaced with like the ellipse tool, things like that, right? Yeah, like there's no, I don't think there's any digital equivalent that will like redirect your brush to make like a semicircle or something, or draw a perfect circle. I suppose it's just deemed sort of obsolete for the most part. I kind of get it. The circle tools are mid. Oh, in terms of like quality. So that's a Bezier tool. Oh yeah, like vector lines. Yeah, I mean, again, it's just like a circle tool of sorts. And with a vector circle, like, it's perfect. You can't go wrong. In fact, this software actually does have a vector mode as well, which is interesting. Okay, so we're gonna add you. We're gonna, let's see. So my eye is like purple. Okay, how much detail on here, buddy? Let's have that maybe. Perfect. Perfect. Beautiful. I look like I'm eating it. Nom nom nom. I'm scarfing down the fucking bugle. Mason chomp. Mace raid. Now watch me eat this piece of fucking brass. all VTubers fear me. Bugle made out of pasta bugle. No, that sounds quite nice. Yeah. I like that. Alright, let's refine it a little. Like, I could go full detail on this, but I don't. Something this size, I feel like there's no real need to. Like, context is everything when it comes to making. Context is everything when it comes to making pixel art, especially. Like, sure, I could make it a better piece of artwork, but you've got to remember it's always going to be viewed from a distance. Like, an emote is not zoomed in. It was the same for when I made my other emotes as well. No, leave it. It's perfect. You like it as it is? Okay, I'll just add a couple extras. Not too much. I get, like, to me, that's not Mason standard pixel art. But I mean, it's the start of something, right? If I just add like a little bit of shimmer. A bit of shimmer, a bit of shine. I'm sure that'll make it a little bit pop a little more. Oops, that's the wrong tool. Yeah, like that, right? Is that good? Is that all we need? Is that what we're after? I think what I'd want. Have a good thing. I mean, it can be pretty much anything. Obviously, I can't draw like an open pair of tits or cock and balls or a JJ or anything like that. But you know, most other things. Anything offensive, obviously. But I don't think you'd be picky anything like that. Somehow, Yeah, like, you know, if it's a character you want to see, or it's a OC, or something, I don't know, from a game. I'll get a Tabs character if you want. No tits, unsubby. I mean, I could do boobs, but they'll be, like, covered in a bra. But pecs. I mean, apparently Twitch allows for pecs. If it's a male-presenting character, then it has to allow it. So, yeah. I'm pretty sure that's the Twitch policy. No nipples at all. I thought it was only for female presenting or something like that, they said, right? Do both, motherfucker. Oh no. I live up to my name. Local bisexual. Right. I'm gonna just optimize the text here a little bit. Round that off. Yeah, like, I'll work on this properly later, but I think we have, like, we've laid out something, right? I think a raid emote is a pretty good shout, Zigo. Like, honestly. I'm gonna probably, like, add a little bit of this. Bit sick green on there first. Get a bit sick green. I don't know why, but I automatically went for green with the text, because I just thought I don't ever use fucking green. Like, green is just not a color I even perceive. It's like, I mean, I do. I'm not colorblind, but still. Fucking green. I just don't. Mason doesn't green. All that, right? Just make pop a little bit. Just make pop just a tiny, whiny bit. Oh. I miss this music. I have not had this music on stream for such a long time. This is vintage. Vintage music. That I used to use on stream. Oh. What is even the thing with nipples? Why are nipples banned? Like, it makes no sense in my opinion. Because nipples are seen as a sexual organ. That's gay. That's gay. Oh. Wait, male streamers can get banned for nipples. Unless it's a hot tip streamer with gym stream. Don't like it. But no, in all fairness, it's all just bound to fucking tradition, basically, isn't it? That's the only reason, like, nipples and stuff are banned. Like, I've been abroad before to, like, lots of beaches where people just walk around topless, whether they're, like, male or female. There's, like, they got nothing to hide. It is what it is. Hey, gotta be careful with Mr. Twitch, aren't we? There you go. No shirtless mace. In your dreams. In everyone's dreams, I should think. I'm very, very attractive, don't you know? Yes, it's amazing. I think that will be acceptable. What do you think, guys? Is that emote material? I can work on it a bit more, like, later on, but I think we have, like, the basic idea there. I like it. Excellent. Why are nipple sexual organs? And most of them are baby feeding organs. Yeah. I would say they're not actually involved in the act of sex by default. It's a bit like saying, like, you know, a lot of people, like, think of nipples and think that's erotic, right? But, I don't know, you get people who see, like, legs, oh god forbid, feet as erotic. So, like, would they ban those too? We're gonna ban legs and feet from Twitch? I shouldn't have said any of that. No, as examples, of course. All right, basically science for excellent. Knowing me, I'm gonna get stuck with the eight. Maybe, I mean, I got it there. It was basically like a fucking meme. That's been quite funny. And the human body itself, right? I see some human bodies, guys. I sometimes think sexual thoughts, and I think that's disgusting. Like, I can't be. That is disgusting. These should be banned. You should be banned from my vision. It's their problem. Yes. And I get the big. That'd be Trixie luck, right? Okay, so yeah, I think that will do for now. Very nice. So yeah, we'll count that as done for the now. We'll see how many people actually pull into the stream. If the queue empties and there's no one additional around, like, I'm happy to, like, have a second entry for some people. Yeah, thank you, Zigo. Alrighty. So, we are now and to return to ye olde wheel. Ye olde wheel. It's not my nicest piece of pixel art, but it'll do as a start, right? And bam, there we are. Okay, there we go. So as you can see, 8x8, got 32 by 32, 64 by 64. 128 is the grand prize, I guess. And Trixel is also an interesting one as well. Ooh, Trixel, yeah, be interesting, right? Okay, I wonder if anyone will get it this stream. Let's have a spin, and then we'll find out who's next. No, Trixel is the grand prize. I mean, they're just as rare, so yeah, maybe. Oh no! Oh no! Here it is, guys. Who's gonna take one for the team? I fucking knew it, local. we'll see. Immediately, 8x8. Oh my god, right. Okay. So. That's a 32 by 32. It's your 8x8. That is one tile on an NES or a Game Boy. So, who's getting it? Who's getting it? I'm gonna wet myself, whoever gets it. If it's local, it's gonna be fucking typical and that'll be funny. If it's Trixie, that'll be atypical and that'll be fucking funny. Whoever gets it, it's gonna be funny. Right, okay. Okay, who's gonna be? Hey up, look who it is. Trixie! Fuck. Oh no, sorry Trixie, my commiserations. Oh, looks like you're the one to take it for the team today. Mason, you have failed. 8x8 is only once. It's only a once. It's there for the memes. I was gonna do a stun rod if I had it. That'd be pretty funny. I will curse you, local. Epoxy 9 crops. Okay. So, Mason, you have failed. A red X, I don't care. Well, I care. I'm doing something. How is that? Like, okay, so I get how red X's fail. Fail. That's failure. How is that Mason, though? Right? We got to do Mason has failed. So we're going to make a tiny, tiny little Mason. Make a tiny little tiny boy Mason. We're going to make the world's smallest Mason. he's a bit small. He's a little bit small. Oh my fucking god. Oh wow. This is something else, guys. This is something else. There he is, Big Doug. Big Doug Mason, there he is. There's the boy, there's the streaming lad. There he is. Fuck you now. Alright, let's have you that. Oh. Delightful. Yes. Mason. Do an orange egg. No. So I'm expecting 8x8. That's the whole point. You don't know what you're going to get. If you did, you know, it was like, oh, I'll give a throwaway choice then. You know? It's actually tipping me for that bad luck. I mean, you had the, you had bad luck doing, like, MaceCom for sure. Like, you really got dicked over a bit there. Pretty sure the personal. I'm pretty sure you're second most deaths behind me only. Right, Mason has failed. Mason has. Oh no! I dropped my mace. That's how I failed. I done a goof and I dropped my mace. Oh no. Oh dear. Oh my. Like, exclamation point. Oh. I had bad luck doing MaceCom, the Tourney, I lost 2 HP back. Oh god, yeah. A few other times. Oh, the Mace on Glyph? Ah, that'd be good luck! Hell yeah! I have succeeded if I could even touch the fucking glyph, to be honest. Anyone could touch the glyph, that's a success. And until it void monarch dodges back to you, of course. Then it's not so good. Right, so I've dropped. Mason has dropped his Dia Mace. Mason, you have failed. Tisk, tisk, tisk. Maybe that'll do. That'll kinda do. Let's give him a Shinsy backdrop as well. Why not? Let's give him a Shinsy backdrop. Oh yes, that's the stuff. Yeah. Oh yeah, it's good music to zone the fuck out to. I like this. What about you guys? I'm having a good time. I'm enjoying this. I hope you are too. Even though they're shit pixel arts, I'm having fun making them. Quite nice this. There we are. A little bit of spot of gold. Spot of gold on here. Yeah, that's Mason. There he is. And like a little... Brighten up the pants a little bit. Give him a little bit of shading. Oh yes, that's the stuff. That is the stuff right there. Right there. There it is. Could have dropped up. You could have tried your croissant. Very good, very good. You going to finish your croissant? I mean, I had bad luck on 23, or rather, I had Zigo on 20. Yeah, yeah. Like, ouch. if there's two people I'd consider to be unlucky draws, it'd be to go against Trixie or Zigo. But no, I think that one called local, I think is a bit of a threat as well. I must say. So, I don't know. We got quite a few powerful players now. I mean, Reaper King is certainly not to be scoffed at either. Like, honestly. Right, hang on. What we got? Doing that. Yeah, I think that's... That'll do. I think that'll do. You know speak? Huh? I know speak? What do you mean? I know speak. Yeah, I speak. Oh, sorry. Trix, who died like twice... Ah, right. Sorry. I understand. Use my right to sue Zigo and get the kids. I mean, what? Oh, no, please don't say you and Zigo are kids. Oh, no. Please, That makes the universe a more complicated place. That very prospect of that. The ultimate rivalry turned ultimate relationship. There we go. Well, add a little bit of brightness here. Oh, I can't believe I fucking shaded that. Why did I bother shading it? Like, for real, what am I doing? What the fuck am I doing with my life? There we go. Mason's failed. Done. I'm on VIV. VIV. Oh, VIV. VIV is... Wait, what number is that? VIV? When V is 5, VI is 6, VIV... Have to be 11, but that's not how one writes 11. Confusing my brain there. Wait, does the... What I saved, does it actually come up with the thing? Let me just check. It's fine if it does. That's fine. Okay, it doesn't come up when I save it. I'm just going to save my doc one moment. Look what stream shiz. Stream shiz. Delightful. There we are. Lovely. IX. That is 9. Aye. Yes, you are on 9. And when you get to 10, I'm going to be looking after you very well, because 10's your final life. Same for me, mind. I'm on like 9 as well, so we're gonna be backliners for the rest of the run until the final fight, I think. Whatever that fight may be. Okay, so that is our 8x8 done. Lovely stuff. So, oh, also to answer your question earlier, Trixie, if no one else appears for the, like, stream, I guess, for now, then yeah, feel free to rejoin the queue. Right. I'm gonna go Kia. We're gonna go... Yeah, there we are. Alrighty then. Next up. This is gonna be you then, local. Guaranteed. Is there a 16 by 16? There is one. Yes. If we get that local. Ah, 16's not too bad, honestly. Oh, baby, that's a 64. Local. What did you actually put as your thing? Oh, you didn't put anything. You big silly. Dare you. Dare you. Oops, that's the wrong thing. You're not supposed to see that. Oh well. It don't even matter anyway. So that's behind the curtain a bit. That's how you actually do things like that on the Streamlabs. Okay, I have an idea. What do you want? Remove that as well. Remove. Trixie's got their eye on the Trixel. The Guardian from Champions Arena. Okay, I'm going to have to get a ref up on that. Well, we're all stuck. Yeah, for sure. I'm going to get a ref on that. One sec. Let's have a looky. Let's get a image up of what our lovely Guardian looks like. So I remember vaguely, of course. I just want to make sure I get the details right. I mean, that's actually quite a big fucking sprite for them too. That's a 64. It's pretty fat. That's like a proper good effort sprite. Fuck. Oh wow, it's taking ages to actually load anything in. There we go, it's on there. Cool. This is not a tab stream, before anyone says anything. But I'm getting just a reference up. I thought I may as well show you guys as I do it, because it's something to look at, innit? Tab stream, no! Hey, if I advertise this as a tab stream, you think people just like barrel in, like, look at my unit, Mason! Like, no, it's art! No! A knife. Mason, get one break. Please. Please, one break. Alright, I'm sure I do have Champions Arena around, actually. In the actual arena. Alright, let's have a looky. It's literally called Champions, right? Champions. Here we are. The first one, that's it. I always remember the first one, then it's the twins, then the counts, then the big bulky bastards, then was it the bandit? Twins, kill count, yeah. Ah, it's Bronze Berserker, so kind of right. Oh, it's the savior. Okay, I thought it was the bandit. Bandit's actually one of the last. Okay. Mason, look at my unit, it's called 8x8 Mason's Failed. Nice unit, Trixie, I love it. Oh wow, you're really trying to... I'm not gonna fall for that one, Trixie. Ice. There's a Swallow. And come. Ice. Swallow. Come. Didn't quite work there, did it? Did it now? Nah. Only once was I had by that, and never again. Never again will I be had by that. Okay, so we've got a beard. Like... quite an Asian style helmet, I guess. Oh no, that's the... Can't see good. Now, interestingly, I have done a sprite of a boxer before, actually. Beat it up using a program or something? I mean, you could. I wouldn't stop you. Okay, so fire armor. No knees. Okay. Oh, we actually have a left-hand L pad as well. Okay, cool. Right. Okay. Yo. Before I get... I'll leave it open just in case. Just in case. Okay, and back we go. There we are. Now, have you looked into my light faction yet? Did I look into a... I don't think so, actually. Don't think I have yet, sorry. Oh my god. 100 sheets? Well, like 100 sheets of pit? What? Dare you, lizard. Fucking dare you. Also, thank you very much for the sub. For bloody 8 months of it. Thank you so much, lizard. And thank you for being around this whole bloody time. How are you doing today? You better be doing well. Also, something you might be interested in, lizard, is I am currently doing a pixel art request stream. So if you want to join the queue, just type in exclamation point join. And maybe you'll get your sprite done on stream. Oh, I shall. Yeah, Trixie got 8x8. So what have we got so far? These aren't like the best sprites I've ever done, but I'm bad at doing things fast. And I can't, I struggle to do things when people are looking at it. So it's a bit different. Yeah, I got a 32x32 of a Mace Raider moat, as requested by Zigo. Looks alright from a distance, like, kinda works-ish. Our 8x8 meme fucking sprite was Trixie saying, Mason has failed. It's me dropping my mace. It's about as good as I can do. And now we have Local, who managed to actually bag a 64x64, which is pretty good luck. Lee, yeah, of course it'd be. I expected as much. It would be Lee. Okay, no worries. Right. Right, so. How are we going to start this one out? Right, first of all, I'm going to look up a reference of a good boxing stance, I think. Well, I have done a boxing character before as a sprite. Like, and it was some of my best work as well, I dare say. But I can't remember the pose off by heart, so I kind of still have to, still have to look at a reference on that. Yeah, lizard subs more than they follow. Yeah, lizard do be subbing. Alright, yeah, Lizard's been here a long bloody time as well. One of the first to know about my streams. In fact, if any of you remember, when I showed that footage of my first ever stream when we started this one, what was one of the first things I said? Hello, Piano Lizard. So, I've been there since stream one. Alright. Let's get some Guardian going on. I'm actually gonna reopen it. I'm gonna leave him on the screen so I can actually see him properly. Okay. Ian Guardian. Lovely. There he is. Beard and all. So we're doing a left lead. Okay, I think I'm starting to see the sprite now. So how I like to work ideally is I like to see something before I actually put things down. Like sometimes I can improvise a sprite, but I never do it by choice. I like to have a think of exactly how I want it to look, and I like try and make what's in my head. I guess I've been your buggest fan. Your bungest fan. You truly have been my bungest fan, Lizard. Big bungus. Oh, thank you for the taxes as well. Hey, Mason, can you also incorporate his hammer in the art? His hammer? He has a hammer? What do you mean by hammer? Is that a thing? I'm unfamiliar. Oh, the hammer ability. Sorry, I see what you mean now. Ah, okay. Okay, I could try. It's a fake then. That's gonna change the composition a bit. So, when he's using the hammer, okay. It's gonna take some thought now. Let's try and outline some random ideas then. Let's actually try and put something together. Oh no, so something like... No, that won't work. How about... Sure, you can! There's like a... Sure, you can, and there's like a hammer there. That's only one idea. That looks like a cock and balls. You can summon it. It's always up to you, no worries. Let's see. Dummy thick guardian. Dummy thick. Oh, can we make dummy thick guardian? It's just fucking big ass dummy thick thighs. You're trying to fight, but his cheeks be clapping. Perfect. The dummy thick guardian, yes. Dummy thick guardian, right there. Right fucking there. You saw it here first on the Maysnap Astro channel. Dummy thick guardian. Dummy thick. That's a thick ass boy. Double cheeked. Damn, boy, thick. That's one thick ass boy. Oh, wow, that is. That's a thick guardian. That is not what one would think when they think of the guardian. Fucking thunder thighs. Look, guys, if you. There's thunder thighs, there it is. If any of you like. Want an artwork of Guardian like so like cracking open someone's skull like a melon between his thighs, then do let me know, you know. A good commission, that one. Alright, that's actually everything then. Can I rejoin the queue? So we've got I'll probably say hold off for the moment. I'll only let people rejoin once it's like completely empty. We have got a lizard in there as well right now. Right, it's actually a tricky one. Just so if anyone new comes to the stream, they can like get their chance to have an art as well. That's a tricky one. That's actually a tricky one. Let's see if we can get any inspiration. Get some inspiration. Okay, dump up. I thought of a composition then, but I don't think it would work on something so small. Like one idea I had is how about the guardian leaping forwards? Like, hang on, let's go back here. Leaping forwards, there's like foot there, coming right out of the viewer, leap there, jumping up. And he's got like one hand raised. How about there? One hand lowered. I'd be like, you can see like the hammer coming from the distance like that. It's just summoned it behind him and it's like gonna crash into you. I chose some binding, Isaac. Oh yes, good choice. My fucking game of all time. It is a solid game. Oh, should be right next to me, Moss. Yay! Looks like a Super Mario. Do 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 do. Yippee! All right, I am trying to really think of how I can quite incorporate it. I'm having a big think right now. Oh, maybe. I think I have an idea, actually. It's not quite true to how the ability works, but I think it actually looked quite cool. I'm trying to imagine it. Okay, maybe something like this. Maybe. So there's the arm. Body here. make a quick draft of it anyway. What do you think of the idea? Draft. Ooh, that's dummy thick again. Oh no. Damn, boy, he's thick. That's one thick ass boy. God damn. He's doing like another jump in the air. I say, whoosh. Helmet here and all that crap. Helmet there. Ponytail thing there. And like the hammer's like kind of just coming down like here with like a nice little shockwave. So that'll probably do it, right? Hmm. Amazing Chick Discord, creative art. Creative art? Fuck's sake. Nice. That is actually pretty much identical. What the fuck? That pose, I didn't even intend that. Okay. I reckon something like that. Alright, so it's gonna be a tricky one then. Let's get to it. This is a 64x64, so it's going to be one of the more time-consuming ones. Right, before I do proceed to it, I'm just going to quickly have a toilet break. Like 5 seconds. Well, not 5 seconds, literally, but 2 minutes, probably. So I will leave you for just a moment. Be right back. And we'll get on with The Guardian. It is like the work of a ghost, isn't it? Hi guys, I'm back. And whatever you do, Trixie, do not open the fucking jar. Why? Because you're in it. You're in the jar. Take that. You're in the jar. Have some of that. I was ready. I knew it was coming. I mean, it's not literally you, it's literally just a text representation of you, but still, have some of that. Okay. So, have a look at the Guardian again. Tricky composition to think of, actually. Maybe. Oh, I know the pose to do. I know the fucking pose to do. Right, I got this. I put my gloves on. My hands are a bit cold. Yeah, it turns out shacks aren't very warm any time that isn't summer. Ah. Okay. What we're gonna do is we're gonna if we wanna get the hammer in shot, we are gonna have to shrink down the Guardian a bit. That's just a thing that's gonna have to happen. Oh, Mason's mitts are cold. My mitts are manly and will tolerate any temperature. Could figure I could say that. No, they are rather cold. Like, before anything else goes, it's always the hands with me. I don't know if everyone else is the same. I actually bought a bunch of warm clothes in preparation for winter because I have a feeling it's gonna be for real. Like, we had a pretty severe summer this year in my time period as well. And I've heard it's pretty much the same where you are. So I expect pretty severe winter. And stress every time. Ah, fair. Yeah, like I take to wearing gloves around the living space quite frequently around this time of year. I think the problem is I'm out of fabric ones right now, so I'm currently wearing my actual fucking leather gloves. They don't exactly help with dexterity. Don't believe games when they say that leather gloves don't hinder dexterity. They do. I assure you. Especially when they're as old, as tough as these ones. Right. Yeah, geez. Right. I had a composition in my mind. What we gotta do? We gotta do, like, body here. Square that off for now. Square it off. Making boxes. That. I'm gonna say something like that. That's what pose there. I just realised the Guardian reminds me just a little bit of like Mokujin from Tekken. I don't think anyone else gets that vibe. I get that vibe. You have the evil ass fucker wearing leather gloves. Oh yeah. Literally leather gloves are the only ones I have left. Oh, and you bet your ass they're studded. Right. Where do legs go for like this sort of punch? So I'm doing like a Superman punch right now. That's what I'm going for. Proper Superman. But like, not that. Leg like that, I think. That. Yeah, something like that. Got some forward momentum going on. Whoosh. And that's where the hammer's going to hit, right there. Okay. I think I got the rough idea. Yeah. Please hit him in the right layer. Yes, I'm in the right layer. Sick. Or am I? Nope, we're good. We're good. We're Gucci. We got this. Okay. What we're gonna do then is we're gonna make another one. Are you here? Working. Layer, we're gonna depreciate the opacity. Yeah, that'll do it. That'll do it. I saw you posted there, though, cool. Again, Lil Mac. Got a better one, yeah. Lil Mac's pretty good. I like Lil Mac. I used to love Punch Out. Honestly though, my unpopular opinion, my favorite one was the SNES game. No one prefers the SNES game, but I do. Honestly love the SNES one. So good. Oh, I should totally play out on stream someday. Fucking love that game. SNES? Yes, the SNES. You know the SNES? There's Punch-Out fucking rocked. So good. The music. I like the big chunky graphics. Sounds were satisfying in a weird way. I actually beat that game as well. Like, I couldn't beat the original Punch-Out, but I beat the SNES one. You mean the Super No, I'm on about the SNES. Super Famicom is the machine that was released in the East, in Japan. Not quite the same, but very, very similar. Pretty much the same, but still. I will not consider a SNES to be a Famicom. That is not accepted here on the Mason Apastro channel. Same for if you call NES a Famicom as well. The Famicom was marketed as a console. The NES was not marketed as such. Mac, no recovery and Ultimate Smash Bros. Ugh, awful, right? Best Smash Bros. Ultimate. I watch on NES, I think, is SRNG speedrun. So speedrunners, I prefer that NES one too. I was NES Punch Out hash as Mike Tyson, which is weird. I know, literally fucking Mike Tyson. But the thing is, right? I only played the release of the game that had Mr. Dream in it. I didn't know what the fuck his deal was. It was just a replacement for Mike Tyson. And he was just this like big grinning white ass man. I was like, I have no fucking clue what this guy's deal is. He's called Mr. Dream. Yeah, he still had like the like missing tooth Mike Tyson has though. So I was confused by him because I thought this is Mike Tyson's Punch Out. That's not in any means Mike Tyson. Yeah, Mr. Dream. Oh no, not Dream, not Dream. No. Look, band, forever. Now game nobody likes more is arcade. Oh fuck. The arcade, no. We don't need that. We don't like that. Absolutely not. It looked weird. It didn't play very well. It tried. I can't be that angry at it. But yeah, it's just not that great. Literally whitewashed him out of the map. Literally. Oh. It's like, oh yeah, so the only reason we'd have a black final boss is because it's Mike Tyson, a real person. It's like, okay, Mr. Dream, right, we're gonna go straight to a white guy. Of course he did. And Mr. Dream had, like, no distinguishing features. He had, like, a big grin, what I remember. And he had, like, still had that missing tooth in some of the sprites. That cheeky, like, Tyson-esque sort of grin. Sort of grit, I should say. It's confirmed Dream's- No! Oh my god, hi, Tormain. I made it for the art stream. Happy 100th- Oh, thank you so much. I didn't see your messenger, sorry. Oh no, glad to have you here, Tormain. Thank you very much. Yeah, 100. One bloody 100. If you fancy a pixel art at all, by the way, feel free to join the queue with exclamation point join and say what you'd like. You'll be randomly selected. See if you want a pixel art. Okay, what are we doing? It's to do with, yeah, licensing. That's exactly what it was. So it's like, okay, we can't have Tyson anymore. So I just made Mr. Dream. They really couldn't think of anything else new, right? I'm pretty sure there was a character that was excluded from the home port Punch-Out that was in the arcades that they could have probably used. Who would it have been? Oh no, it would have been the fucking hillbilly guy. But nobody would have wanted him as a final boss, I don't think, so maybe not. I'm being a bit slow here. I need to actually get this together. Let's actually get some shapes going on. A flare. Yeah, so with sprites of this size, my preferred size of sprite is very fucking weird, guys. If there's any pixel artists watching, like, I don't fucking care what you're gonna say. My ideal sprite size that I've worked with most, 84 by 84 is my preferred tile. Which isn't even a tile. That's the weird thing. Like, I've made, like, a bunch of, like, beat-em-up style characters before, and it will always be 84 by 84. That's just my rule. It's this weird sort of size where you have to make big decisions on how you depict the faces in particular. But it's just right so you can get lots of shading detail in, you know? Really good, really good. Oh, what we got? Heartbroken. Sorry. Random pixel, exactly. Break head mod? Oh, there's a new mod, bloody hell. How'd you come to that size of the preference? 64 by 64 just wasn't doing it for me. 64 by 64 is obviously the standard, right? The thing to regard is, I would probably say, I might be incorrect in this. I think a lot of home console, like, beat-em-ups went for that sort of size. Because obviously their tiles would be 32 by 32, I think it is, on, like, I don't know, Mega Drive or some shit. Or Genesis, sorry for any Americans. Genesis. And obviously they wouldn't fill those entire tiles with content. So I feel like they're about 80 or so sprites tall. Like, you look at, like, I don't know, Axel from Streets of Rage or something, right? I know Final Fight sprites were pretty fucking titanic. Oh, Final Fight sprites were really good for their, at their time, but they aged so well compared to a lot of the other games. Oh, so hi, Mum Slayer boy. How you doing? Oh, no, I haven't used it yet. Okay, you got a Headbuster mod. Yeah, Mum Slayer, if you'd like a pixel art, or at least a chance at getting a pixel art today, feel free to press exclamation point join, and you have a chance to get a pixel art this stream. What size it'll be is randomly decided. Right, so what we're gonna do like that. Oh, it looks like it's bounding off the wall now. That's quite cool, actually. We'll lift him up. Squeeze him up a bit. Oh yeah, so with this one, the shape's not going to be very nice. We're going to work in with the shading, I think. I think that's the key ingredient here. So 64x64 just doesn't quite do it for me normally. I like to have that a little bit more. But it's obviously because the composition of the shot is obviously a lot less than that many pixels big right now. Yeah, it's random order. I think the lizard is also in the queue right now. Okay, so let's get some texture, I think. We're going to start off with... we'll start with the arm, we're working with the body. Alright, so what gold palette can we conjure? So yeah, also, if you want to see what this palette can do, I have these nice little examples I made earlier of what you can do with the palette if you put your mind to it. 52 colors in all, this palette. Texture. Oh yeah, that's some texture right there. Like a block of bismuth, if any of you ever seen that there. Got like metals, dirt, stone. You can do quite a lot of it. What a nice little palette, really. So I can see, like, here, like, that's quite a brassy tone. I could use something like that for Guardian, right? So the main colour of it is, like, that. What's the third of that? range. Okay. Texture barely Noah. Same, bro. Same. Alright, we're gonna fill you out. Look at my own. I'm gonna look at my own fist for a few seconds. That. Okay. Started drinking a new energy drink recently as well. Oops. It's called Dragon Energy. Never heard of it, but got it on like Amazon for cheap, cheaper than pretty much any other energy drinks there. Actually, pretty good. Actually, pretty good. Bit dry. Kind of reminds me of Relentless, actually. It's like even cheaper. God knows energy prices have gone up a lot. Alright, so knowing that's that, we could add that there. Okay, I can see it's, I can see how I can develop this a bit. I see it, I see it. You guys probably can't see it, and that's okay. My artwork is fucking atrocious before it comes together. Famously so. So one thing that's interesting about art, I find, is... obviously, the more time you put into art, the better you'll get by nature. Because obviously experience and whatnot. If you're someone who doesn't draw and you say I'm bad at art, then that would probably be why. But there's also like a right way and a wrong way of learning things. I've gone through a lot of my life just learning the wrong fucking ways. So I have some really bad habits when I draw stuff. So I can make decent end results sometimes. My drafts make no sense to anyone. Not even myself sometimes. Alright, so that'll be like that. And the arms on the guardian are actually black. Right, okay. So that should be, would be that sort of colour. So like that. Sort out that. Well, not black, but like dark. Dark reddish. No, yeah. It is sort of black. Basically there. Okay. He has got the elbow pad on the this arm here. We'll do that. We'll pick that as like a more reddish or hue for the moment. Yeah, that'll be a nice palette. That. That works like that. I can define like his chest shape in a moment. Huh? Oh, I wasn't erasing then, that was weird. His reaction's already bronze. I like the colour of what bronze is nice. It is a good colour. That's like copper. I think copper is an underrated tone. I think that's a really nice metal tone there. I just literally redrew what I just did. Oops. Oh, that'll do. A bit more definition, maybe. What I find a lot more these days as well is more and more people are starting to prefer silver to gold. Has anyone else noticed that? Is anyone, like, you know, given the choice, people, would you take silver or gold as a colour? Most people I meet would say silver these days, which baffles me. Yeah, copper is nice. Yeah, I like silver better than gold personally, right? Like historically, like gold was like the color. Like it'd be obscene to like gold more than silver. Oh, they're selling more than gold. Potassium kind of gal. you might have to remind me, what colour's potassium? Yellow like a banana or what? Okay. Does that have like a muscle chest? No, it's like a barrel chest. Okay, so it's like... Cody ass like that. Alright, okay. She's like fluoride the best. Ah, yes. Explosive. Ah, yes, explosive colour. I like the explosive colour. Personally, my favourite colours are the ones that hurt my eyes. Mm-mm-mm. Do love me some eye-hurting colour. I'm not gonna do this. It'd be nice if I could get some facial detail on there, really, but see what we can do. Composition's all a little bit whack. I said, if I'm not happy with it, I'll just like improve it off stream anyway. Imagine you probably want like a red skin tone anyway. Most people sort of assume their units will always be red, I find. How many people like build for blue? I suppose, you know, as the player, it's the one you see the most, right? We just about wedge that on? Yeah, we can just about wedge that on, that's fine. Comes like that, so come down around here. I'm team blue? Fair, fair. There's sodium to fit that role. Lord. Ah yes, what's your favourite colour palette? Potassium, sodium, and fluoride myself. Mm-hmm. Love me that colour palette. Really, really pops, really complement each other, you know? I make sure it looks good for both, but for art, I prefer red because I like to believe the player it's the player versus the world. Ooh. Yeah, I do try to build with both generally. I don't like having team colour on there. I try to make things that have their own palette, and I just don't depend on the blues and reds in the team color selector, I guess. Whenever I can remember. The Boron Stan, nice. Fine choice. I tell you what. Is that more the actual color? Because like, he's not really golden, he is like a bronzy sort of colour. I don't know. My screen filters do weird things to it as well, so I'm not sure. 18 colour. It's for units who can't tell what colour they are. Yeah, makes sense. Makes the sense. Okay, so we've got like a sleeve going on here, so I'll be like a brown for now. BB boy. One sleeve. And a black here. Fine. Yeah, this mouse is not. This mouse is not. Do not like using a setup for art, but the only way I can really stream it. Only way I can stream it. For ages I told myself I'm never going to do an art stream. But here I am, stream number 100, doing a bloody art stream. Hey Mason, oh hey Reaper King, how you doing? Good to see you. If you're looking for a piece of pixel art, just type in exclamation point join and type in what you'd like. And yeah, Mason, my life can take you, oh yeah, for real. I've all my prototype units in tabs. You like design of Mason. Like all my prototype units in tabs. Oh right, yes. Yeah, no, I like that. I'm sorry. Hey, what? I'm starting to read right now. I'm sorry, it's with us twats. Well, you know, I mean, I gotta grace some people. So, who else would spend time with you twats, right? Right? You know? Someone's gotta do it. It's a dirty job, but someone's gotta do it. Who better than a villain, you know? Nah, I couldn't ask for a lovelier group of twats to watch my stream. Nah, I get it. But nah, I am very grateful for those who are here. Truly. Yeah, at the beginning of the stream, anyone who didn't see it, I actually showed... I actually used footage from my very first stream to open it up. And I could put... I fooled Local and Trixie. Thinking it was actually just part of the normal stream. And Zigo was like, oh, you're quiet. It's like, haha! Little does Zigo know, that was my first ever stream. One of the first things I ever said on my first ever stream was, hi, Piano Lizard. And me, like, you kiss who the fuck I am, but be lame, so... Maybe order the first MAT contenders alongside Mason. Fuck me, that's a task. Jesus Christ. Alright. I mean, I'll see what I can do. There'll be very low detail. Oof. That's a hell of a big task. Okay. Alright. Do that there. Leg armor is that color. Brown for the trousers. Pants. Many cool them here. But take away the outline there, that's fine. Take away the outline here, that's fine. Don't worry about it. It'll slowly start to take shape. Like, there'll be just be a moment where you're like, ah, as I'm doing it. Not sure how long that's going to take, though. Who knows, maybe you've already had that moment. You're like, oh, I see how you're doing it. I see how this is. I see it taking shape. Okay, so we will develop this a bit. How are you guys enjoying yourself so far? Would you like to see more sort of content like this? It's a little bit weird for me, really. My first time doing anything like this, and normally I'm very conscious of doing artwork in front of others, honestly. Not usually my thing, but I'm actually having a bit of fun. I didn't expect my best artwork to come from this stream anyway. So, you know, with that mentality, I don't really feel quite as much pressure as I thought I would. And I'm gonna use this brown for a moment, just to signify that there is a difference here. Yeah, it's fine. Detail, hardly know her. Other than him driving to work at MacTech. What? Wait, you know someone called Detail who drives to work at Mac 10? That's an interesting character, you know. Who the fuck is Detail? Detail to me just sounds like a ripoff of Data from Star Trek. I don't know, I just find that concept quite funny to me. Someone just being called Detail. I don't know if it's the same with other armed forces, but in the UK, it's also used to address a specific group as part of a squadron as well. So someone says, like, Squadshun is like how you announce a squad. If you announce a specific element of a squad, it's detail shun. An interesting thing to note. Alright. Okay. Starting to see it. With like rings on the boots here, so do this. Yeah, sort of doing it. Will I do outlines for this? You know what? I'll actually do solid outline for this one. Sometimes actually, like, I just use shaded outlines, but this time around I'm actually just gonna go all in, invest in pure solid outline. One of the people who taught me art said to only do that if you know exactly what you're doing. I have no idea what I'm doing. I do it anyway. And that's what I mean by I developed bad art habits. Probably why. Not there. I think it's starting to come along. I'm starting to make out some sort of certain elements of it. You guys think it's coming along at all? I can see the starts of something for sure. And what art software do you use to create pixel art? I guess everyone uses A-Sprite. No, not me. Because I have to be different, don't I? I use a software that very few people use called Marmoset Hexels. It's an interesting software because you can do shit like make trixels. I don't even see that. I don't know, if I were to go nuts, I can literally do shit like this. One sec, show what trixels are now. So like, there we go, trixel grid. Like this. To make trixels like that, you can do fractals, which are another kind of trixel as well. There's quite a few interesting things that Hexels has. Another one is there's the actual Hexels themselves. These are what Hexels are. And you can't get this shit on other software. That's the whole thing. I don't know any software that has this level of variability in a grid. Like, fuck it. You can actually customize your own shape as well. Onto shape. And we say custom. I don't know, let's make it into... Oh, fucking hell. Wait, can I have more vectors than that? I can! Oh, shit. Oh, no, that's weird. Oh, God. I don't know, let's say I wanted to make like an M or something, right? I can literally make a brush of M's. It's a thing I can do. I don't know. M. You see it being manipulated on the grid on screen? It's not the clearest in the world, but yeah, it's there. I don't know, sort of. you can see it forming, right? And I can literally, like, just draw in any colour on it. Make that a brush. The best part is it's all vector as well. So you can scale it to any size and there'll be no blurring. So there's a few reasons why I did go for... Hexels, I suppose. As my software of choice. Alright, and go back to the raster layer. Yeah, back to normal. Right, where were we? Oh, I missed a bit of chat there. I'm so good at this. I looked down for like two... Ah, I'm not that good at this. But thank you very much, though. Yeah, that is unique. Yeah, it's pretty cool, right? Hexagons are the best of guns. I mean, yeah, how often do you see Hexel art, right? It's very, very rare. Very rare. It's a very interesting medium to work with. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Make a Rulino triangle? What's that? Rulo? Rulo triangle? Rulo triangle. What is that? Oh, no, yeah, you can make those. I call that shape a cam. That's usually what that shape is used in, is a cam. Yeah, I just call it a cam. Okay. I mean, yeah, you could easily make one of those. It would have to have, like, a certain number of, verts, though, which are, like, the 3D modeling element of it. So you couldn't make it perfectly round. Like, you couldn't make a circular palette on here. Not fully. You could do, like, hundreds of verts. Actually, what is the maximum vert count? I'm curious how many I can do without crashing this. Anyone who doesn't know what a vert is, they're like the points of a shape in 3D. Like, let's say you do a square, each corner would be a vert. I'm curious, how many verts can you do on Hexels? Can you make a titanic amount? I mean, I got 33 here, and apparently that's, like, just fine. Oh shit, there's some custom ones here as well, actually. You could do, like, houndstooth and shit. One sec. Let me just have a little bit of fun here. There we go, let's try this. What can we get out of this? Let's use like a nice orange palette. We can actually see it. Yeah, like that. That's interesting. That's like the closest you can get to a circle on there. Let's see. What else have we got on here? They got houndstooth here, which is like a very retro design, if any of you recognize that. You see a houndstooth around on random things. It's actually very common. Yeah, so there's like loads of different options you can use. Make bricks, if you really want. Build it up like that. So yeah, that's one of the things I really, really like about Hexels. Is I love pixels. Pixels are my favorite. But I like any geometric sort of grid-based medium. I love that element of control, and I like the fact that I now have options in what I can do with that. I am invested now. I'm really selling Hexels here, aren't I? Yeah, like, it's a very underrated program. It really is. Like, A-Sprite, I'm sure, is solid. I have got A-Sprite. Ooh, it's misaligned. What the f- Uh-oh. Right. Okay, this is the part where Hexels does go a bit bad. Right. That's a problem. I don't know if any of you can see that, but the pixels are currently misaligned. Fuck. How can I undo that? Okay, I have to go into vector mode for it. Yeesh. Yeah, so I kind of broke it. Yeah, one problem about Hexels being a smaller program is it is very unstable. You get anomalies when you copy and paste things sometimes. And if you have a really big document, it can actually corrupt over time as well. So I had a document before. I still use it sometimes these days. How big was it? There's a pixel art palette tester that I made for making a new palette I had that was about 200 odd colors. It's very specialist. And this document was about 8,000 odd pixels, right? Which in the grand scheme isn't that big, but for something pixel art based, it's fucking huge. So this program can't really take that. So over time, I keep coming back to it and it degrades. The things that I've done before are suddenly, like, corrupted. Like, they got different colours on them. Or their lines disappear. Shit like that happens. It's really weird. Sometimes images even blend together. It's very, very strange. Very strange. Yeah, other than that, though, it's a lovely piece of software. You can do animation on it, too. And Lord knows I've used it plenty for animation. In fact, my intro screen... is actually made using Hexels as well. Yeah, well weird, right? Well weird. So I've never seen in any other program is that kind of corruption. Usually when a file's corrupt, it just doesn't read, right? But no. In this instance, it just fucking manipulates it in some bizarre way. And there's nothing I can really do to stop it either. So I know that one day that file is going to be nothing like what I remembered making it. The problem is I still go back to that file for references on how I coloured things. So, yeah, a little bit of an issue. a bit of a whoopsie poopsie. The thing is, I haven't seen an update for it in a long time either. I started using the program. Whoa, that's blurred. What the fuck? Okay. Yeah, I fucked up Hexels somehow. Not sure what I've done, but I fucked up Hexels. Like, you see, that now has a gradient. Maybe. Nope. Shit, what have I done? That's bad. I don't like that one bit. Irritating. Very weird. Weird. Yeah, weird is the word of the day here. It really is. Like now the pixels are misaligned, so not really too sure what's happening there. So I'm gonna save and reopen it. I'm gonna save and reopen it. See if it resolves the issue. Like, I don't know if you guys can see it, but I can definitely see it when it's misaligned. There we go, we open again. Wee-wee, no. Can I open up again, Hexels? Yeah, there we go. Back in biz. Okay, back on here. Oh no, it's like all misaligned now. Fuck. Man, that's annoying. Very annoying. It's weird. Right? Yeah, that's a lot of bloody ball sacks on that. Okay, whatever. I guess we'll resume. We'll resume regardless. Okay. So we're making progress. Starting to come together a bit. Down cuff here. Outline that. Oh, that was a really thick calf there, actually. It's quite cool. I already miss dummy thick guardian. Not gonna lie. Dummy thick guardian was the best guardian. Damn, boy, you're thick. So I just realized the whole... I've been playing different themed music this whole time as well. But it's not like horror music, it's not. But it must have changed ages ago. Right. There, that's there. That's going to become brown now. Like, approximately that. Do it. This color here will turn into this. No, it won't. Into this. No, it won't. What can we do with that? No, that's way too strong. How can we manipulate this in the right way? With that, maybe I could try out... That's a flat. No. We'll do this and see if we can maybe do something like this. So what we'll do, we'll lift that a little bit. That's actually quite awkward. We do art now so we can do arts together. Ah, oh, yes. That's a very based idea. I'd love to see what you do as well. One thing I find really nice is when you see like an art streamer and you make art alongside them, it feels like you're on like a little productive journey together. I always like doing that. Okay. Oh no, I'm not happy with that glove anymore. Glove's not quite right. And there's a lot that's not quite right, but it is what it is. I'm just going to outline the hammer as well, just so we have something down for it. Let's use a line tool for the moment. Now the hammer is almost always depicted as like flat that way, right? Could add a little bit of an angle to it. So like that. Like that. Like that. Roughly that sort of idea. So we have something down. Okay. Ew, it's gonna like double corner. Ugh. Do something about that. Me, I'm actually making art of some art right now. Oh, you're doing some art as well, are you? What sort of art are we working in right now, peeps? Are we making like digital drawings? Are we doing pixels? Are we doing music? Writing? What are we up to? This stream is an art corner. I'm happy to have an art corner. That sounds great. Don't go look at my stream if you don't want. Just look up occasionally and be like, oh, we're making progress together. We're on our own little mission, and I like that. That's one thing I love to see, it's just a bunch of people doing creative shit. Makes me happy. Right. Check you here for now. Pixels, though while I may have creative mind, I'm not the best at showing it. I guess I can no worries. But, it is as it is. I mean, everyone's got to start somewhere, and I'm not the best at art either, really. All right, look at this! What's this? It's not good. But, you know, we all get better together, we all work at our own speeds. So if it's something you enjoy, just keep at it. You'll get naturally better. And even then, ask yourself, is it something you want to be into? If it's something you want to be into, then just keep doing it over and over, and you'll get better in time. One problem I find a lot of people have, though, is, like, they may not necessarily be in it for the art, necessarily. Sometimes it's a matter of they want to express an idea or a concept, and art, and, like, visual art becomes the way that they want to depict it. Like, I don't know, let's say you made, like, a creative world or something. You're like, how would I present this to someone? And, like, visual art is the first thing that comes to mind, right? That's how I started getting into art, was I like made like comic book things. And I started drawing cars, lots and lots of fucking cars. God, I used to draw a lot of fucking cars. At least 8 a day. God, I like drawing cars. And journey after journey happened and I ended up here. Embrace my inabilities and I'm making it my own. Fuck yeah, that's the way. I accept the fact that I can't do art, but I make up for it in my therapy skill. Ooh. Into many things, but wait, what? This is how I'm going about it right now. Very much jerry-rigging my own shit. Ah, fair. I started doing it anyway, and trying to improve. Good. You enjoy yourselves. Better enjoy yourselves or I'll punch you with a mace in the face. Right, so obviously this is too short now. De-stumpify it a bit. Yeah, it's taking a bit longer than I thought, but I always knew a 64 by 64 would take a bit more time. It is what it is. Yep, do that. Trying to think of how to get a good bronzy tone on here. Oh, that's a... Ooh. That's a bold color choice if I went for that. A bold color choice. Maybe that could actually pass. That's too red. What about that? Is the bronze berserker? Is he more a goldy color or has he got that brown tint to him? I'm not sure. Oh, popular opinion. Drawing hands. Oh, fuck yeah. Drawing hands sucks. He's gonna get 128 by 128. Yeah, boxing gloves. So yeah, boxing gloves are easier for sure. Do I even just try and do enough like 40% time? Or say fuck it and just run nubs. Oh, you know, did I say Bronze Berserker? I meant Guardian. What am I on about? What did I say Bronze Berserker for? I just had bronze on my mind, I guess. Ah, actually quite similar colours. That's interesting. Yeah, Guardian, I meant. Guardian is meant to be more gold, though, right? I'm gonna actually try and make the colours pop a bit more. I'm gonna try and just have fucking fun with the palette. I've given up. I'm gonna go full fun palette. We're going for it, guys. We're going for it. You'll see a full-on Mason colour experience here. This is what we're in for. Yeah, to anyone who hasn't seen as well, check out these nice little colour blocks I made. Using this palette I'm using. The sort of stuff that could be in store. Metals. It's blurred. Why have you blurred? What is wrong with you? Program. What are you doing, Hexels? Why have you blurred them? Fucking nutters. Don't get it. Okay. Keep developing. Does he have shoulders? I don't think he has shoulders, does he? No, just the t-shirt thing. Okay. Add like a little white dot there to represent an eye. Do. I'm gonna go. Nope. Go this color. Go this. Yeah, I can see that working actually. So I do make this that color. I'm just gonna band it for the moment. So yeah, that's a one thing that happens a lot in pixel art, you'll see, especially if someone's newer to it, is a thing called color banding. It's where your shading basically becomes something like this. Say I wanted to just depict that there's light on this, I just go bleh. And then I'd be like, oh, what's the next dark tone? It'd be bleh. I'd be like, oh, what's the next tone? Got that orange on there, so it'd be bleh. This is where you have this very flat sort of appearance to colour, rather than regarding depth. This thing I used to do an awful lot in my old pixel art. Sure. Overwatch 2 Qs or something else. Overwatch 2, bloody hell. No, yeah, that's all I've heard about is fucking Overwatch 2 meming about Qs. So I've seen quite a few streamers have been able to get their hands on it. Honestly, I actually used to really like playing Overwatch. Part of me still wants to go back into it. Like, obviously not the original, because that's gone. But second one. Not a big fan of the developers, obviously, like Activision Blizzard, but this looks like a fun game, to be honest. Ooh, my stomach is making some noises there. Right. Okay, so there's no like abs or anything on this one. It's literally just a round sort of deal. Do this. That up. That up. We'll also take away this one. Take that into jacket. Up there. So are you playing Overwatch right now, Reaper King? That's just a general comment. Oh, just Reinhardt myself. Just a fucking love playing Reinhardt. Honor! Justice! Reinhardt! Aha! I'm trying to. Any chance is your character Reaper? By any chance? At all? Reaper King. Like, whichever answer you give is going to be pretty funny. Whether it's a yes or a no. Nah. You sure about that, Reaper King? You sure about that? Silly. That's pretty sus to me. Quite sus. That is so sus, you get a free sussy stylophone for that. That's very sus. That's your shitty sus. There we go. I was that sus. That's how sus it was. Okay, so what I want to do now, try going to like a reddish hue here. I want to go more purple though. That's like the best way to do things like this. Yeah, a firm belief I have with pixel art as well. Don't use black. Just don't. Get a shade into dark. Shade in dark purple. That's what these are. Dark purple. It always makes it a little less harsh on the eyes, I find. Even with outlines, dark purple. Is your name literally derived from playing Reaper? I just realised, Reaper King. You're actually just not a Grim Reaper fan at all. You just love Reaper from Overwatch, specifically. Is that what this is? I bet it is. If I look under that bus, is it just going to be a shit ton of Reaper posters or something under there? So turn that off a bit more here. Yeah. Outline helmet a bit. Already darkest. We might have to lighten that up a bit. No, I don't like that. Don't like it. Try this color. Color, quote unquote. That meaning shade. Kinda. Nah, you must be insane. Right, okay, I see. I see how it is. Not a hold on air. Alright. Okay. Yeah. Naru Hodo. Mr. Frodo. But, good question. Haha, real good question, right? Snap Astra asking all the real questions. Question of the stars, that's me. Mason the question guy, who says the question. With such catchphrases as, here's the big question, and, oh really? Snap Astra, question man. Oh, I feel like I've told you before. Have you? Have you really? I recall not this. The answer is no. Okay. I'll believe you this time. I'll believe you this time, Buster. I'm going to go for this color down here. We're going like ultra vibrant colors here. We're going like fucking Mace FX. Oh shit. Oh god, that's too vibrant. Ah, help. We're going like Mace FX level. Just like the shader from Maytabs. looking alright. We're getting there. Hey, Snap Astra, just asking questions. Longest stream when? That's a good question, actually. I wouldn't say no to a MOGA stream. Might have to do that sometime, actually. Good fun game. Maybe I will do one sometime. But the games list is fucking huge at this point. There's so many games I want to play on stream, it's unreal. So many. It'd be pretty funny if all the mace heads showed up. I am 100% going to be the person to die first. I fucking know it. I'm gonna go in there. It's like, I'm just going to do a task. Mace head number one shows up. First one to see me. Whack! What? I would net. I don't know about that. Reaper on your pan. Very sus. Someone very sus would say. Ooh, Reaper. Are Reaper just kind of try and pull you under the bus? That's what Reaper does, you know? I think you could trust Reaper. The face of a trustworthy Reaper. As Reaper King. Yes. Hello, we're just speaking a ton of nonsense. Right, guys, no venting in chat, okay? No venting. No sus activities, please. No self-reports either, won't have any of that. My vent! Nope! No vent. Ventant. Vent. Vent. Yes. Fuck trains and fuck buses, they are the bane of my life. Are you currently going through a truck bus train ordeal, or are you on about the weekend? What do we say? Alright, vent. Oh, vent. Very good. Very good. That is a vent. What? No banging chat. That does it. Right, get out of here. Get out. Out. Banned. 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 Oh. Damn it. It didn't even work. I tried to do a fake ass ban, but it didn't even work. Pathetic. 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 I'm gonna round this off a bit. Round you off. Make you round. And you round. And you round. Make you extra voluptuous, my friend. Ooh, that's voluptuous. Ooh, Guardian. Ooh, Guardian. Ooh, my. Oh my, Guardian. Ugh. And literally, yes, though, fucking trains are shit right now, yeah, always the buses, right? Hour on the bus to take up. Fuck buses, I hate buses, they're shit. That's a piece of shit. Hate them all. What time do you even, like, tend to get out of work? It goes, like, you're, like, past... Oh wait, if it's replacement bus, then it would be okay, never mind actually. I think I know the sort of time scale. That makes sense. Current job I'm running now. Besides villainy, of course. Getting out like 10:30. Quite nice. A lot earlier than my previous job. Makes me rather happy. That'll do it. Okay, because strikes earn the new line being worked on. But to be honest, I never stopped being shit since I lived up here. Fair. Not untrue. Man, I think that's starting to come together. I don't know if my bold palette's paying off though. Is the bold palette paying its dividends, or has it gone too far? I think it's gone too far. I tried to really ramp up that fucking vibrance. I feel like it's just kind of it got out of hand. I had fun doing it though. I can still change the palette pretty easy as well, so I'm not really scared of that. I had like a little dent in the armor as well, because I feel like the Guardian would have like a dent in the armor. Dent and ding. Dents and dings. A little patch there. About that color. Yeah, that'd be like a little bit of messing up on the armor, right? I imagine the Guardians are all together. Surely. That looks nice, but that's not what I'm after. Do you there. Oh, the size is random. It is indeed. Yeah, Trixie had an 8x8. And a local magic get their hands on a 64x64. But I had no idea what the fuck to do with the composition. So, the actual character itself has ended up quite small. But like, because what they hammer in the shot as well, is like, I see what I can do with it. It's kind of, the characters themselves end up quite small. Smaller than I anticipated. Separations from XCOM, two death, motherfucker. Well, got anyone got a one time? Ah, there's no one times one, but there was. There did exist an 8x8, which was the smallest. And that was the one that Trixie got, which was Mason has failed. There was also a raid one by Zigo requested. That's one I'm on right now. Yeah, I don't feel this one's gone quite to plan, but it's okay. Things don't go quite to plan, you just carry on anyway. That's what it's all about. And so, I will carry on. Not there. Yeah, maybe. Lighter palette here. It's coming together, it's starting, it's getting there. Oh, that should be that colour, wouldn't it? It's that colour there. Yeah. If anyone gets the trick, so I'm gonna do something. Don't know what, but something. Oh my god, don't do something, please. Do nothing. Do nothing. Okay, I think it's might be somewhere. It's looking better than it was a while ago anyway. Still not really where I want to be. Let's try this here. Yeah, I think I am gonna desaturate the colour palette. I'm just gonna try to be ambitious then. Because good lord, I love a good vibrant palette. It's a weakness of mine, what can I say? Red. Okay. And put here for now. You here. Hexels also has an option to make things glow, which is quite cool. Let's see if I can actually show you. Might be a bit soft right now, though. Hey, it'll glow. So brighter colours will actually now just automatically glow. And by default, it's always set to on as well. Interesting. If I add like a bunch of orange to the scene, it will start going orange. I don't know. Oops. See, holy shit. Guardians made the ultimate punch. Punching a star into oblivion. Looks amazing. Oh no. I don't know what you mean by oh no. Guardians become more powerful than ever. Surely this was your goal. What punch? Look, I may snap Astra, son of the stars. But I'm gonna be a fucking orphan if this guy keeps punching the fucking stars. Bro turned into sight, literally. Fuck me. Hey, yo. Right. And up there. Actually, I think the glow actually kind of works with this as well, actually. Right. I would like to add a bit more downward motion to it. Add a bit more downwards. I think we're almost at a point where we can at least leave it and then like revise it off screen. Certainly not a standard I'm quite happy with, but you gotta take your W's and take your L's. I will experiment a bit with the palette as well, see if we can get I would consider to be a good enough one. Where? We'll use that for this, that for this. The top of the diamond area here. That can be orange. I shall make the destroyer of the stars, aka the criminal that made Batman. Oh my god. Guy is Maytab's grandfather. He'll count would then technically be Maytab's great grandfather. He was technically the first made champions. Was he? Bloody hell. He also just looks the oldest as well, just by his age, physical age. Okay, that's cool. Yeah. Yeah. That'll do. Let's get somewhere. I'm gonna add a little bit of shine onto here as well. The light source was originally on the top right, but now there's this big fucking hammer. And I feel like that's adding its own sort of light to it. Interesting, right? Also adopted the Guardian. Oh, okay. First doubles. Oh! That's not a math. I still haven't really decided anything about my Maytab's lore. Well, I mean, you got nothing but time. Like, Maytab's lore is moving slowly forward. I mean, I haven't got the second part of the campaign as of yet. Yeah, I mean, we're just waiting for the next weapons table, I'd imagine, first. And obviously, part of the store in campaign story would be you do the training session with Local as well. Because Local has the Maytab's Fighter Initiative. Which I feel like your main character, whoever you play as, would go to during the story. Sorry, it's taking a little while, guys. Like, usually I'm someone who just sort of sits and stares at a screen until an idea, the like image appears. It's me trying to be a bit more bored with it, I guess. Like, I've done worse, but it's not my best. I'm glad you use all those units, by the way. Ooh, thank you. Honestly forgot the purpose or lore I had in the story. You live under the bus, and the bus was destroyed by Zeego. And then you forever vow revenge on for bus kind. No, I have no idea. I did no such thing. Lies. Lies, Zeego, lies. How dare you come here to defend your name? Let me slag you off. Can we agree upon me and Yasa, you are the head professor at the face the center. Oh, what the hell do I call it now? It's like the university at Centra, which is like the metropolitan hub. Can't remember exactly what the hell the university is called or anything, but yeah, you're in Centra. You are the headmaster there. You're the one who leads the training program to whatever end that it is you do so. Right, we'll add a little bit here. That. Do that. I'd like a little bit more lighting here, just to say that's the hammer there. Yeah, that's doing stuff. That's doing stuff. That's coming out. That's working. Put that one there, put that one there. Yeah, that's going together, right? And for this, that. A nice orange crotch, because why not? Sounds about right. I also an inventor, probably the one who created the Maytab's prototype units. Ah, okay. You physically created them yourself. That was until Zeego came along and destroyed all the buses, thus ruining your trip to work, and then you vowed revenge. I'm just going to call Zeego the instigator of all things in Maytabs. So he'll cause all the problems. Rumor has it, Zeego made Beast 7 sad once. So, you know, you should really, really, you know, really lay into the guy, you know? Oh yeah, there were the Shadow Empire ruling or something. Shadow Empire? I can't remember. And I think the shadows were part of the Maytab's lore for sure. Can't remember exactly what they were doing. Maybe you meet me and I help you train all the prototype units. Then Zeego Nation happened. I think my creations are natural to make contrast with Zeego having factories and stuff. Possibly. Well, see what Zeego does anyway. I'm just force feeding him words at this point. Zeego, you did everything here. How could you? You destroyed everything. Okay, I think over here. Take way. Yeah, there's a bit to fix here, really. But I'll probably leave this in a few minutes. And finish this off stream, I think. Not quite perfect, but it's getting there, right? Would you guys agree that it's getting there? Question mark, quote unquote. Kinda. It's just getting shorter now. Okay, it looks amazing. Oh, thank you. It looks good. A man and his big block of butter. The Guardian is passionate about butter, clearly. That glare. Like, the man. Just look. He loves his butter. Butt. A block of butt. Butt. That says butt. Shut up. Okay, we'll leave that there for now. If that is okay with you, local, but I will come back to it and give it a revision. Off stream. I'll post it when it's done. Yeah, I think we got the foundation for something now anyway. So I'm not quite as good in this sort of circumstance, but it is what it is. Okay, so I'm gonna spin the wheel and determine who gets the next piece of art. And then I'm gonna have another quick toilet break, and then we'll do that one. Hey, do that here, get rid of... It's come a long way. There we are. Yeah, I got a lot to fix on that, for sure. Hey, and we'll put that onto the correct layer here. There we go. Nice. Okay, so move on to our next thing. Our next thingy majiggy. There we are. Okay, so we're gonna spin the wheel first and then we'll see who it is. It was close to the Trixel. There's a 32x32. Much more manageable size. Okay, and who will be guessing that? Who's getting the 32x32 today? Let's find out. And... Is this person even here? Mum's there, boy. Are you still here? Like, if not, I'm just gonna probably bypass that. I don't think Mum's there, boy, is here. Mum's there, boy. Hold on. I'll get their attention, hopefully. Okay. Well, I'm gonna go use the loot for a moment. If Slayer's not back by then, I'll probably move on. If they come back while I'm in the toilet, just tell them to think of what they want me to draw. Okay, BRB. Thank you. Ahoy, and we're back. And Mumslayer's here. Hello, Mumslayer. So, what piece of artwork did you want made? But you didn't really specify on your join. Guy? Okay. Anything else? Anything else? A wobbler. Okay. A wobbler. A guy and a wobbler. Anything else at all? I will literally just draw a wobbler. Oh, the guy is a wobbler, so okay. So I will draw a wobbler. Is that right? A wobbler? Just a wobbler? Anything else with that at all? Yes. Wobbler it is. Wobbler it is. Oh, and attacks. Lovely. Thank you very much. We will do a wobbler. Okay. We got the initial outline of the guardian there, which was another wobbler and a guy. We'll finish that one off stream. Right, now what is going on with this layer? Why is it blurred? Really don't quite understand what's going on there. Got pixel mode and that goes away, but oh no it doesn't. What? You are blurred. Yeah, this stuff, I don't get it. Why is this? What is this? Why is it doing these like half tones? I don't get it. What are you doing? Oh, pixel scaling, I reckon. Scaling? Nope. Not understanding. Nope. So do that. Nope. That hasn't fixed anything. Already understanding what the hell's going on with this thing. Being very weird right now. Whatever, I guess. We'll continue. Regardless. This weird blurred background. Whatever. Whatever. It's okay. Okay, so we're drawing a guy that is a wobbler. Okay. Like this sort of deal, yeah. They have quite long bodies, really, don't they? That's it. We'll just mirror that. It's fine. Let's just go. Oh shit! We'll do. Let's do this here. Let's do this. Yeah, I've seen like the concept art for tabs. Wobblers look like way different. They didn't have used to have eyes. I wonder if at any stage they thought the game was gonna be like serious rather than playful. Nope. that. Very rectangular body, no chest definition. Really, it's just such a simple thing. That do we come like a dummy thick wobbler? You just like give him a real ass, real thick thighs. We got a sumptuous, voluptuous version of a wobbler. Delicious. Delicious, sumptuous wobbler. Dummy thick thighs. Thunder clapping ass cheeks as well, yep. Thick, absolutely maximum thick. Right, that's it, a thick wobbler. There was nothing said about what kind of wobbler it was, so therefore I have made the decision this is now going to be a dummy thick wobbler. The dummiest, thickiest, big-ass fucking wobbler. The wobbliest wobbler that ever did wobble. Tell you what, we're gonna do, actually. We're gonna do this. I'm just gonna go... pomp. Perfect. Instagram model wobbler. My god. Alright, so we gotta give like go back inwards for like the rest of the body now. Standard wobbler body, just all of the meat is in the glutes. Pure bottom heavy wobbler action. That's a dummy thick wobble. Man, how can I make the... I want like the body go like... standard wobbler size. Just huge thighs. You want a bit of calf as well. Oh yes, that's the stuff. Bit of calf. Oh yeah, there we go. We're like the perfectly like straight wobbler body. Damn, boy. Thick ass boy. Oh my fucking god. Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. Perfection has never been so visible. Has never seemed so obtainable. I'm just gonna like put you across there. What do I give this wobbler? I feel like I need to be holding something. That's up ahead there. Wobbler holding anything. It's like just your clapping sound. Like this is a wobbler that is not designed for stealth at all. Clap, clap, clap. Gun. Gun. Oh, did you guys watch that British anime dub I posted in memes? It's fucking delightful. Do you swear to save all humanity and mankind? Fuck off! So inappropriate, it's wonderful. Okay, so we want a gun with it. Okay, gun. We'll have, I don't know, what we feel like. Python. We'll have a Python revolver, why not? Or like, Being a warbler is probably like a bit too big, right? That's how his proportions always go in tabs. The guns are way too big. The guns are the dummy thick ones. I swear to God. Fuck you, God. See, I swear to God. Very good. Very good. Thick warbler. Oh, Jesus. This is, this is why God let me live on Earth. Just so I can make wonderful creations like this. Move down a bit. How does the... Well, the warbler's head is kind of weird. It kind of like expands outwards a tiny bit at the top. Like it sort of like starts off thin, then gets a bit thicker, then goes back inwards. Like... I don't know. Something like... That! Something like that, right? Imagine not having a Python revolver that shoots Winchester bullets. I think Warbler shoots bullets that are thick. 100. It's like an oval head. It's kinda. Yeah. Now, if you look on like the animated trailer, they depict it in like a very, like that's a more. I envision it as like a trapezoid with a cone on top of it. That's how I've always seen like the Warbler head. Like, oh my God, an evil warbler. Oh my God. Okay, that's it. It's thick and it's intimidating. This warbler is thick and intimidating. It's also very delinquent. I'm just gonna do this. Why not? Fuck you, says the warbler. Warbler's saying fuck you. Why not? Why not? Oh, I'm gonna turn the glow off. Oh my fucking God, oh no, this is not the time to arrive. This is the bad time, oh no. Hi guys! How's it going? Oh my God, it's Bandu! Hello Bandu! Martian rain invasion. Ooh, good weather. Hello Bandu, how are you doing? How you doing, Bandu? Hello Vaders, how are you doing? This is my 100th stream. And I am none the wiser for it. I'm currently just doing like little pixel art requests. Of varying degrees of quality and content. Some of it is very questionable, but yeah, we're doing a little requests. You can press exclamation point join if you want to add something to the queue. I don't know how much I'll get through today, but we will see. Wait, this is your what stream now? Number 100, Bandu, my 100th stream. It's been like, oof. Thick. Yes, the thicker stream. Oh yeah, it's a thick stream as well. Yes. No, apparently it's thick with this one, but maybe not so thick with the other things. Oh God. Yeah, my 100th stream. Since I started, like, August last year, I think? I'm not sure. Not too sure. Can't quite remember. So currently I'm just doing like little requests and stuff. And right now I'm just kind of screwing around. So anyone who knows like totally accurate Battle Simulator at all has these like red characters. One of the viewers, Mumslayer, has requested me draw one of those. I decided, fuck it, let's make them dummy thick and make them give the middle finger for no reason. I'm currently making the warbler in tabs. Yes. They can also be blue. Could be blue. I know, I kind of want to stick with the red here. I feel like a blue one in the background, like looking on, like, oh, I wish I was the main wobbler right now. In the background, in the shadows, lurking unhappily. I don't know how the hell you pose a wobbler. Wobblers are weird. They have like long bodies and they're like perfectly straight. So you have a dummy thick one instead. Oh. What different colours? Stuff like skeleton suits. That's true. Right, okay. So we have invested in the idea that this needs to have a middle finger right now. At least I have anyway. Like, no one else told me to, I just really wanted this. Let me have this. Let me have nice things. There we go. Okay. So we're just gonna like shade it a little bit. Oh, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. Got like haunted ass eyes. This is the most cursed, blurst wobble. This is the most blurst wobble ever, basically. Yes. I think I'm quite. Yep. Oh yes, that's the stuff. You can just hear this thing run across the battlefield. Eyes clapping loudly. Far surpassing the volume of any war cry that could come to it. This is the true call to arms, people. This is where it's at. Red. Perfect. I just realized this palette hasn't really got a good option for like working off red. That's interesting. Never really know. Oh, there we go. That'll come through. I don't know. That color's quite working. Orange just isn't really clear enough. It's terrible. I love it. Well, I guess my favorite color is red now. I mean, it should be after seeing that. You've seen the level of quality we're dealing with, guys. This is the superior level of shit. This is what it's all about. This is all about, baby. Oh my god, yes. It's harrowing. Right, one of the problems is that background is kind of throwing me off with the color choices a bit. So I can't really tell that gray revolver's there. Do that. Something like that, right? And I also don't really think of how is the wobbler doing this considering a wobbler doesn't have a hand? Yeah, pants or a shirt? Probably not, but if you want them to have like fucking denim jeans or something. Short shorts. This wobbler needs short shorts right fucking now. We're gonna use with this color. Right, good at that. Yeah, all just gotta like come down a little bit. Like that. Yeah, there we go. Oh yeah, baby. Now we're cooking on gas. Now we're cooking on ass. Oh, get out. Bandu, what have you brought your audience to? There we go. It's beautiful. Beautiful. Absolutely glorious. Absolutely gorgeous. There we go. God. Can I get a belly button to be extra cursed as well? Oh, fucking hell. My back dog was walked. Oh. It overgrew one like a tree. Jeans? Billy jeans? Sprouted out of his hand. It's now, right, it's using a tree. Let's give you a middle tree finger. I don't give a shit anymore. I'm going wild with this. It's using a fucking tree. It's like operating the tree like it's a middle finger. It knows what's up. It knows exactly what it's doing. It's just gonna stare at you with these horrifying eyes. Oh my god. It it's spectacular. There's monster factory levels of shit. I love it. Love it. Let's get some... Oh, let's get some real shine on those thighs. Oh, let's go. There we go. Maybe not. I've said too much. It's a little too much. Okay, okay. We're gonna dial it back just the tiniest bit. We'll do that. Ooh. And maybe... Oh yeah, that's the stuff. Right there. You make the unit way too big and it gives the unit the tree weapon. Oh my god, how big is this fucking thing? Are those white eyes, like straight white? I think so, yeah. Did you want another color? Oh. Fucking shorts. What is this? What is this monstrosity that is being designed here? Can you have a bit of shine on this too? Oh, perfect. Perfect. This could not be any better if we tried. This is pure art right here. This is the content we've come for. This is what we needed in life. You and me both, chat. We needed this. Can I made an kill face for it? Oh no. I raised them back. Local, you might want to stay back. Stay away. You don't want to see this. You don't want to walk in on this. The most cursed wobbler ever made. Dummy thick thighs, short shorts, a tree that's also a middle finger because apparently green fingered, python revolver, Tabs fanboy hooter. God, literally. I don't see the spell the bubble barrel bullets and the weapons. Yes, this is true. I did indeed. Fucking general images. It's wonderful. That wobbler mason drew. That's... Yeah. Yeah. That is correct. Should we make this an official character? I should make this an official character in the tournaments. You know what? Originally, I was scared of the brief, where it was just like, oh, a wobbler guy. I was like, alright, whiskey, nothing. I don't know what to make of that. It's ended up being something quite beautiful. Quite beautiful indeed. Just look at it. Oh. Slappable thighs or what, right? Mm-mm. I wonder what a wobbler is physically like to the touch. Are they like skin? Is it like flesh they're covered in, or are they like covered in hard material? Like, what's their deal? What's their deal? There's a whole other definition to the phrase green firm. You got it. No! How do you have 15 viewers? Who is all here? Oh, we had a raid from Bandu, we did. Raid from Bandu, very kind of him. Yeah. I apologize any of Bandu's raiders that are still here for this wonderfully cursed content that has been generated. Slime, you reckon? Maybe. Rubbery or leather? Rubbery, I could see, actually. I reckon they have a rubbery skin. I could see that. Should we really work hard on this tree? Can we make, a really nice tree? For no good reason other than yes. Add luck. No, can't do that. There we go. It's a really, really nice tree. Right. I'm not sure what the fuck I really made. I'm proud of it. Don't know what the fuck it is, but I'm proud of it. This needs to be developed further, I think. I think this is just the beginning of something wonderful, to say the least. absolutely wonderful. Ooh, really working that shading right now, aren't we? Go on, let's add a bit more. Oh yeah, some of that. Sweet ass shading. Beautiful. Just beautiful. Now you guys tell me you can resist that. That is irresistible. It feels like polygon. Maybe it's a Matabs unit when new colors come. You're absolutely free. I make my OC as a Matabs unit. Ooh, sounds good. Sounds good. Ready for the tournament. Right, okay. We're gonna add a couple more things here and then we'll probably move on to the next in the queue. Anyone who would like a pixel art piece, press exclamation point join and you may have a chance to win a pixel art of some fucking variety. Whatever in the Lord's good name this is. So we've had like, someone asked for a raid emote of me, so I made that. I made an 8x8 pixel art of me failing and dropping my mace. I made a start on, oh my god, what's going on there? Ooh, that's a bit busted. Whoops. I made like the start of a piece of art there as well. Of a guy called the Guardian, broke down a hammer. That'll be finished off stream. And now we have what is clearly the peak of my artwork here. Like, come on. Come on, guys. You look me in the eyes and you tell me that is not just good stuff. Okay, I think we're good. Mum's there, boy. Are you quite content with our outcome? I think you're quite happy, surely. Think five save lives? Abso-fucking-lutely. Abso-fucking-lutely. And lives do fuck, yes. They save lices? Wait a fucking minute. Hold the fucking phone. You know what people say that art, Jay speaking, will flex the arse in some way? And determine if it seems lies or not. Oh no, oh no. I want thick thighs to end my life. Based local. Just plain based. Totally get that. Keep that going there. Whoops, I don't know what happened there, that's weird. Whoa, stop. Cease music. What are you up to there, Mr. Music? We'll carry on this one. Yeah, I think that was optimal. Okay, we'll see that, call that one done. Thank you, Mumslayer Boy. That is a surprisingly great brief I was given there. I love it. Love it. Who's also the thick wobbler or the yellow and pink Marth guy? Ooh. Wait, yellow and pink Marth guy? Marth guy? Yellow and pink Marth guy, yeah. Who was that? Shit. Yellow and pink. Oh, that one! Fucking hell. The leader of the. Yeah, the leader of the Chaoticons. I don't know. Whatever we made together was a wonderful thing. It really was. Okay, we're gonna go to the spinny wheel now. And we'll see what's left. Right. I don't know if anyone new has joined the queue, but we'll find out together. Oh, actually, no, I need to go back on here one moment. Okay, so currently in the queue, we only have Piano Lizard and Reaper King. So, who will be first? Let's see. It is... Ah... There we go. You can look at that. Lizard, you're up. So, you wanted me to do Lee, your OC. Okay. we'll do, if we go back onto the screen now. Yeah. Ooh. Well, I wouldn't woo yet if I were you, Buster. There's still a spin of the wheel you gotta have. We'll see what you end up with. It will be quite sad if it ends up being a 16 by 16. Right. Let's see. Spin the Wheel of Fortune. What you gonna get? What you gonna get? Oh! Bravo! You have the maximum fucking size. Yo! You are the winner of the 128 by 128. You have the biggest sprite. This is nowhere near gonna be done on stream. I gotta be honest. Not even close, but we'll get a start on it. Work it up for about half hour, get a good establishment, and then see where we can go from there. Bloody hell. Okay. So what we'll do then is we'll go here. Oh yeah. Fucking wobbler. Okay, so it's a fair bit bigger. I'm gonna go here. Okay. Right, I'm gonna just see if I have some Lee references lying around. I'm sure I do. Somewhere. Over the rainbow. Actually, I think I can actually remember what Lee looks like pretty well, actually. That is quadrupedal, the guardian. Quadrupedal? Oh, yes, it is. It is. Well. Actually, yeah, yeah. 64, 128. Same for the 32 versus the 64. Like, it's all in all to the power of 4, I think it is. That's the general calculation. So 8, 16, 32, 64. Here we go, we work that. And the 128. Oh, 128's real big boy pixels. Fucking hell. Alright. I'm generally of a smaller scale than that, but not too far off. Right. I think what we're going to do then, are we going to do this? I'm trying to think of the sort of pose. So Lee is still a thief, right? So we're gonna do some lines of this. Do you decide the... Can I make a suggestion? No, of course you can. What do you want? I'm citing a name for me. I give my characters titles such as Thrak the Prepared, Zane, Sky Voyager, Crank Self-Made Cyborg, but I need a name for me. Local, the bisexual. Local bisexualized? He deserves a lovely full pink ball gown. Bloody hell, okay. Ball gown. Let's have a look then. So like, you're about like a full big ass dress sort of deal, right? It's me and Basilava. I have shotgun, harpoon. Oh my god. Local bicep. There it is. There it is. I think a leather armor is bringing that scaly skin. Okay. Right. Okay, that's an interesting contrast to what I was originally thinking. Because originally I was like, ah, thief, the leather armor. We'll give a go to the ball gown. This will also test out the pink elements of this palette as well. Right, let's have a think then. Let's compose this. Big think. I can actually stare at the screen a little bit for this one. I think I can sort of see the pose. feel like it should be holding something. I'll work it out.
Right.
Okay. Local, the local bisexual in your area. Bisexual, the localized. Local, the tinker. Tinkerer, the localized. Oh no. Right. Okay. What we're gonna do? We're gonna have to go from roughly here. Think about how we're gonna propose this. No. This mouse is not the one for this art. Not that. Make a start on the idea at least. A big ball gown, right? That's what a ball gown is. It's like your big ass sort of dress. It's perfect, that is what you're after. Good. This show looks splendid. And Yep. That's way too angled, whatever. We can work that. We can work it out. Do that. There. When it comes to larger pixel arts, with smaller ones, you kinda have the choice. You can either like outline and or you can like sculpt. Like with the wobbler I sculpted with this guy, I kind of outlined. With large aspects like this, I always outline, as I said. You can treat it more like a drawing when you make it, right? Right, here then. Like this. No. Alright, so we have ball gown. Would Lee wear sleeves? Would it be maybe shoulder sleeves? How does that sound? So like... sleeves... like obviously it crops inwards because ball gowns are always like tight like a corset around that area. Yeah, but it's lying around here usually. Rather cool. I mean, some of them are so frilly you don't even see it. That. A cake. There's a big frame going on inside of it. I felt like the Bronze Berserker. I have two Monitor Charges, Aegis Shield, Power. Ooh, interesting. Local, Bronze Aegis. I'm with Local, the Tinkerer. I may change it. That's. Are you that gonna pose something like this? No, that's not right. Big brain moments. So how does a sleeve like this sound to you, Lizard? Something like that. Just do tiny hands. Perfection. Yes. Done. Bada bing, bada boom, baby. You like the sleeves? Excellent. Okay, cool. Alright. Start bringing together. Side eye. Oh, there's a work about that. I have both melee and range options with charge and a harpoon sword. Here they are. That was deadly. Alright. Oof. Pose. Are we gonna go for the elegant sort of arms crossed sort of deal? I'm gonna go for something more flamboyant. Maybe just... Aha! No, perfect. I know exactly what. How about another middle finger? Ha ha! No. Okay, okay. Local battle expert. I like that one. The choice to be made here. It's like the shoulders kind of speak for themselves. Yeah. Do this. I'm like. Oh, a little bit. Just a little bit of a groove there. Oops. Not straight. Just like a little bit. There we go. It's not that. Something like that. Okay, that, to be honest. Fuck you. What is wrong with me? Oh, fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you! Okay, they're a cat now. I don't care. There we go. There we go. Alright. This was destined to happen on a 128. This was destined to happen. Right. Also, we're going to close off there. Have them slightly rotated. Arm pose. What's he doing? That's the question. Maybe it could be. Maybe something like this. Arms will be right here. Yes. I don't know. Or thing like that. Maybe. Like. Holding the material of the dress. Like lifting it like a. Almost like a curtsy, I guess. Yeah, I can see something like that, right? Good stuff with a cat. Fuck you! Would this be so? They wear leather armor usually, so it's like a change for them, right? So maybe like a hand to the face, like thinking like, ooh, this is nice. Obviously less cursed than that, but still. That like looking down towards the dress interest thing. So like. Ooh, isn't this nice compared to my leather armor? Pogaruni. Yeah, I can see that. Yeah, like, oh, that's joking. Just joking. I kind of see the composition now. Actually, that's just a pog. Pog with additional nose. Maybe they can do like a noot noot from Pingu. Noot noot! I need to stop. I need to stop. I need to have a stop. That's. Yeah, I think that's a nice pose. Yes, I feel that. That's good. Noot noot, motherfucker! That's. I reckon sitting down on the neck would be nice. I'll go with the shoulder design that way. Not gonna lie, on my other Twitter, I do have quite a few follows of fashion pages. I may or may not have investigated fashion of this sort before. This clothing is fascinating. And what you can do with it and the possibilities are always interesting too. I don't know, Jester kick format, my unit is actually pretty good, but I was just entering many times for fun, not to win like last time. Fair. No, I'm not going to be entering to win either. Like, Echoes of Mason made me unhappy. I didn't like that. Okay. This is a bit different to what I normally draw, so I've just got to think of how to pick the reptilian humanoid head. Obviously, these aren't ears, they're like meant to be frills, rather. That's pretty out of usual fare. Nah, I appreciate it. It's good. So I feel like Lee was always an image I was going to make eventually. It's the one that never really came about. Like, I did Lee driving a car once, and that was about it. Technically, I've drawn Lee before, yeah. Technically. That jawline. The jawest line. The Linus jaw. Does Lee have, like, a mouth that kind of, like, almost is like the cat thing, doesn't it? It's like, that, right? The Dream's face. His face reveal, or like fucking every 20s internet white man influential streamer with curly hair, right? Yeah, T thing, just like that. Okay. I'm getting a feeling for this one quicker than I was on the Guardian, I must admit. What eye style should we go for? Yeah, the problem with the Guardian... I had an idea, and I was like, alright, we want to get the hammer in shot. I was like, wait, how are we going to do this in that 64 space? It all kind of got thrown off. This, though... Honestly, getting a feeling for it quite quickly. I felt that dress might want to rise a little bit. The guy is meant to be like doing like a Superman punch. Like one hand raised, one like forward. Oh my fucking god! Oh my god, Loco, are you hearing this? Lizard has made the most based observation of the night. Fuck me. That is literally the Chad. Oh my god. Can we give like the Chad pouch as well? Like, ew. what's the writing? It's gonna say like, ouch on his chest. But I have like the Mohawk. Oh my god. Wow. Chad! It's the fucking Chad! It's literally the Chad meme! How? Chad. Oh my god, that is so funny. Fuck me. That is so good. Oh wow. What a treat, guys. We were greeted by the fucking Chad. The fucking Chad himself. Oops. It's like touching the hand of God. Oh my god, that is fucking hilarious. That is fucking hilarious. Oh my god. That is the Chad. I want to commit a little bit more to this. I want to full on like go to town on it. I want to do that. There we go. That was crusty. It's a crusty Chad. Crusty Chad. It's like a crusty crab, but even worse. Touching the hand of God. How does it feel? The Guardian and Chad are now in a relationship. Oh, fucking Jesus Christ. Oh. Oh. Oh God, oh, everything hurts. That is so fucking funny. Oh, that is delightful. That is just delightful. Okay. Oh. Okay. Okay. All right, why does it look crunchy? When you shrink an image down, what you gotta remember is you're lowering the amount of pixels on there. So with most programs, if you enlarge or resize something, it blurs it. It like tries aliasing the pixels, it's called. In hexels, it doesn't blur ever. Instead, it actually tries to guess where the pixels would be. So if you want to enlarge or shrink an image and make it into pixel art, this is how you'd make a template. For hexels, another big plus of hexels is it can do that. And not enough people know about hexels. Oh, that was fucking funny. Chat. All right. That's quite nice, actually. We need to fix the proportions a little bit. Like, I feel like the dress should be higher. Yeah, I feel the dress should be higher. Put up for a moment. Like, if I'm right, a ball gown would eat up the body mainly, right? Quite high up, settled. Yeah, eat up the body. So, yeah, like that, actually. Like that. Yeah. So, like, the arm, that didn't really have a full thing anyway. Okay, fine. And so we would fix it. Oh, fix it thusly. Been lifted there. Come off the frame a little bit. Frame underneath is still like, could be doing that. Okay. Well, the face is definitely gonna be the hardest part on this one. Like the dress, I think I should be able to get pretty nice. Face. Definitely at this size we should be having real eyes, not dots, I should think. It could have eyes like that, but not really it. That's a tricky one. Right. These eyes are like a yellow color, if I recall. Just working it like that. What about that? No. Okay. Yes, remembered. Yes. I'm doing this entirely from memory. No, I've seen Lee enough times. I may not remember every feature, but I remember some of them. Pupils are either black or red. And they're black, right? Or in my case, purple. Like, roughly like that. The foundation to get us started. Oh, that's quite cute. A little blush there as well, I think it'd be nice. A blush. How'd you draw that on? That's fine. There. Yeah! Yeah! That's nice. I like that. Well, get rid of you. So, how are you guys finding pixel art streams with Mason anyway? Would you like to see more of them in the future, do you reckon? I prefer just a standard game experience. Very unusual doing them, I'll say. Maybe I'll get better at drawing pixels fast as well. It'd be good practice for me for sure. These streams are nice. Ah, how do you think so, local? So I will be refining your character later. I'm not quite happy. We're somewhere. We're not quite there, though. We're somewhere. We're almost there. It seems like this is super chill. Super chill Mason energy. Oh, Mason. What? Okay, it's not chill anymore. Fucking Reaper King. I said, oh, hey, Mason. That's it. It's not chill. Panic time. Panic stream. Chaos. Hi, Reaper King. What can I get? Can you check Discord? I made something for you. What we got? Oh, hang on. Hang about. Oh shit! Is that like a? Hang on. Is it like a CRT TV and it's got like static spilling out of it? I'm sure compared to the average streams, yeah. How about general images? Yeah, I think I do see it. It's a little small, trying to make it out. That's a static TV, is it not? It's like TV static. Like, yeah. And yes, it's basically this is what the Echoes of Mason could have become. A terrifying prospect. I do like the way it's just like the static's dribbling out though. I think that's very cool. Ah, nice one, Reaper King. Looking good. So Mace Comb at the top. Oh, the color contrast in this TV is awful. One sec. Oh, fuck me, yeah. Sorry, the contrast in this is pretty nasty on my TV. I do apologize. Nice. Looking good. Nah, go on. Give it a display. It's what the Reaper King hath made. Blurred out because old. And there he is, Big Doug. That is one static boy. The static boy that is also a Macecom. Mace.com user. Yeah, so I said, oh no, it's all good. But tell you what, actually. Yeah, I actually really like it though. I really like the static is fucking cool. I've not really perceived static as like a liquid before. I think you're onto something very nice there. Ah, keep up the good work, Reaper King. Very good indeed, sir. Very good. Give Reaper King some love, folks. Put you back on to the screen. Yeah. Tell you what, actually, one thing might be able to give you one bit of help here, if it does work. Back onto Hexal. So remember I mentioned about Hexal's being able to scale without ever blurring anything. So as you've given pixel art, should there we go, so you can kind of see pixels here. What I can actually do, oops, don't happen then. What you can actually do on Hexels is you can actually save an image and make it like 50 times bigger. Like this could be made into like 4K if you really fucking want to do. So this what would look like a glow effect on it. What happens if you do that? Glow! Yeah, if anyone makes any pixel art or anything and they don't have access to Hexels, like feel free to like send them to me and maybe I could enlarge them for you. It means that when you have a preview on like Discord and stuff, it doesn't come across as blurry. And I'll show you now. Show you now. We'll do and open a new one. Save that. Onto that. And that has got to be one of the first Mason fan arts for sure. The first one made by an actual true fan. Hey, thank you very much for it indeed. I do love it. But I want to send it back to you bigger. You can display it to all your friends and be like, yo, look at this shit I made. It's fucking sick. Hang on. Hang about. I got this. Oh boy, that's taking a while. There we go. So Hexal's like special ability is the ability to enlarge. I'm not editing or anything, I'm literally just making it big for you. There we are. And what we do is give that to you there. And I can enlarge it up to like 1,000 times if I want. There we are, make it nice and big for you, and I'll go back here to where you were. And there you are, my friend. Oops, it's got a white background, I do apologize. So yeah, if you wanted like if I want pixel art enlarged, I can do it losslessly. it's got a white background on it though, so it's actually kind of shit. Sorry about that. Oh, thank you very much for the artwork. I love it. Very fucking cool. Very fucking cool indeed. Static spillage is the best part of it. So I'll probably delete that one and give you like a proper one later, because that white background is annoying. So yeah, thank you so much. Right. Oh shit, there's chat. My world have certain heroes, one of which is Zorn, who is a ruthless commander. One who will do almost anything to get what he wants. One of those things is cursing himself to persist after death. I have two people called Zorn, a ruthless commander, and Zorn the Undying. Oh my god. Yeah. Oh, no problem, Reekering. Thank you again. No, off stream, I'll give you a proper resizing. Without the background, I think would be nice, right? Not this ugly white thing. Yeah, it's a neat little thing Hexels can do. Because that's the one problem with pixel art, is when you, like, send it over to someone. I had this problem all the fucking time. Like, look how, like, you know, you look how crisp this is, right? But then, if I send that on Discord, it's like... Like, you see how small it really is. You zoom into it and it's just a blur. Pixel's weird like that. But with Hexels, it just understands that a square is sacred and should not be blurred. Which is something I can very much agree with. Right. There's a place for blurry art, mind, actually. Like, if you're going for a certain aesthetic, for sure. Oh, but that was a hot topic for discussion, like, last year in the pixel art community, really. Right. Okay, so I think the face has got a good sort of foundation going on. I reckon just some, like, visibility of scales would be nice here. Just, like, a little bit of texture for the shoulder. Fill it out. Just gonna put it like that for now as like a little marker, I suppose. Yeah, that'll look good on him. This, I think a little bit downward, put you here. Should do the job. Alright, you said pink as well, so let's look at some pink stuff. See what palettes we can get out of the palette we're using. Which name I cannot say. No, that's not a sleeve. That is literally just a bugger up. That's fine. I think that's looking quite nice. I think that's going to have a really nice end result. Definitely see it. We don't... Yeah, there's no sleeving here. It's literally just the arm. Yeah, like that. Nice. We got a good start going... Ooh, this is going to be the trouble. Shit. Green. My palette's... are really bad at green. Scheitzer. This could be an issue. See what we can do to work it. Not quite. Kinda. I'm sure we can make it work somehow. Yeah. Yeah, that'll come along. We can do stuff like that. Put you here. Nope. Yeah, like that. Yeah. They start brushing it. Yeah. I said, I don't think it looks too bad here. Look at that green and that pink. It's quite interesting. Okay. looks so cute. How do you think so? Yeah, looking good. Yeah, most definitely I see something good coming out of this. I think we've got a good foundation here, for sure. Obviously we're going to rework things, so that's going to look a bit more smooth. That's not a scar, that's meant to be a blush, it's going to be. I'll cut on that now, so I remember. Ooh, that's too much there, too much. A little too much. Blush could be like I feel like a flesh tone would actually do it quite nicely. Yeah, kind of like that. Give it a bit of that. Line tease it up a bit. You basically end up with that again. Do that, and pretty little. Oh no, hang on. That was the snoot. Two slits or two holes? It's slits. That kind of right. No, not like that. Here. Laugh. Not quite. I like that, really. What else can we do? Get this pink here. That's coming along nicely. What else can we do? Would you want any more accessories? Gloves, sitting on the wrist, sitting on the head. I think most of the ornamentation will just come from the dress itself, I should think. Yeah. Yeah, I think we have pretty much the form that we're going to use here. Just do a little bit of working into it. And then, yeah. Yeah, we stream for like 15 more minutes or so, roughly there. I'm definitely not going to finish it tonight. But, yeah. Finish it off stream for sure. Let's have this one being clutched a little bit. No, because the hand's there. So, we might. I'll work that out, that's fine. Look at that. Yeah, that works. This. Suck is legal. Yep, it is indeed legal. It is indeed. I personally think it's quite a powerful one. I think in the right circumstances, you could really do a lot of damage with it for sure. Okay. I want to look at what sort of design we put on the dress as well, actually. I don't know why. The first thing that comes to my mind is like a daisy. Ah. The classic, like, pink and white, right? That's no daisy I know, but still, I know. Yep, that's a daisy, yes. Daisy, one whole daisy. Fuck yeah, at this point I'd be better off using a circle tool. This mouse isn't it, guys. Oh, Mason, this looks really good. Oh, thank you so much. Glad you think so. Mason, star. Hmm? Star. Oh, can you call me Mayon? Ah, yes, Mayon. Mayon Apas. Mayon App. Eustra. If you're thinking floor, okay, good. I reckon. Something along the lines of this. So, pretend that's good. For start, pretend that's good. So just like. Come on. Okay. So I have like a daisy design here. I reckon to go with the nice skin tone. Maybe some like little vine designs, maybe. Or maybe it would attract. I'm not sure. Little like vine designs. Going to like flowers. Leaves. How'd something like that go? I saw a head but one shot a cheek. Oh boy. Yeah. Headbutt. Sounding more powerful than I expected. Officially, I think headbutt is still out of the Marth booklet. I think. And I think I, after reevaluating, will not be adding it into the competition. This is quite interesting, actually. I'm quite a bit of fun with this. Obviously, each of these lines will become a thrill as well. So, like, blah, 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 blah. Oh, then again, maybe I should make the frills before I put the design on so that I can see what the colour palette will look like. Because obviously the frills would have to be a different colour. One would think, but maybe not, because there's a lot of ball gowns that don't have a different colour for frills. It's like all one sort of text, all one material. We'll see. There's a lot of options here. A lot of options. Okay, I'm for now actually going to probably I'm not going to delete the flower for now. I'm just going to leave it on there so I can be reminded for later. Okay, I'm going to leave it here for now. For tonight. I'll resume with this probably off stream. I gotta finish the Guardian as well. Maybe work what we've already made. But yeah. Guardian, in my opinion, I think I gotta re-proportionize it a little bit. We can go somewhere with it. And as for Lee, I see great promise there. I think that could become something really nice. Yeah, that's actually... I was kind of fearful of what the 128 would end up as. Because obviously that's like the big challenge. I think we're definitely on the right track. And I think it's nice that you got it, Lizard. I think it's nice that you got it. It wasn't like biased or anything. The fate just rolled for you. That's awesome. Okay, so yeah, that will be it for today. We managed to get... like, 5-ish things done, I guess. I mean, this is just Spider-Man at this fucking point. I don't know what the fuck this is. That's alright, it's got some charm. That is what it is. That's looking great. I'm quite happy with how that's going. This has a good concept. Needs development and sculpting. Yeah, that's where I'm at. Okay, cool. Wait. I think we're done here. So, let's have a look at who'll be raiding today. Yeah, Mason, thank you. No, thank you, local. Thank you. Right. Well, that's the end of the 100th stream. You only get one of those, folks. Only one of those. I'm glad it ended up as a pretty good one. Right. Who are we raiding today? Sea of 200. we'll see. We'll see. I mean, I'm on 110. 110? Oh, no. I think I was on 111 at one stage. Whoops. Whoopsie doodle. It's almost like rewatching me. It's like, oh god, he's actually terrible. What the fuck? You're 101. Oh, how dare you? I'm 110, I'll have you know. Alright. What are we feeling like, guys? What are we feeling like? How about some Core Keeper? Like a nice mixture of moods there, I think. Core Keeper sound good? Yeah? Great. Great. I like to hear. Oh! So, I'll let you guys have a vote between two games. Cult of the Lamb or Core Keeper? State what you prefer. State to thine preference. What? There we go. Core Keeper? That's one for Core Keeper. And it's Core Keeper. Okay. That is where we're off to then. Now I played either of them. Oh, fair play. Oh, so that's for tradition. Heinous art. Oh, fucking course. Okay. Okay. Actually. You know what? I'm actually going to go for Cult of the Lamb. Reason being is I think the streamer's a little bit smaller. I think they'd appreciate the raid a little more, maybe. So, we are going to be raiding. Oops. Do some raid and raids. There we are. So, we're going to be raiding Rekris today. Rekris. There we go. And they are currently playing Call of the Lamb, which is actually a really fun looking game. I actually really want to play it myself. Yeah. I think I might actually add it to the roguelike roulette, to be honest. Yeah, thank you so much, everyone, for coming to my 100th bloody stream. My 51st week of streaming, and a celebration of over 100 followers as well. It was a big one. I'll post some of the artwork when it's more refined. Other than that, though, thank you very much again. Do take good care of yourselves. Wait for next timetable. And I'll see you guys around. Oh, also do look forward to Saturday, because I am planning to have the Maytabs table released with any luck. Okay, well, Royal Val. Goodbye. Thank you very much, everyone.